the stage and threw a shoe at him. Shoes started flying back and forth despite Houthi's attempt to keep talking and ignore the disruption, and before long, fist fights were reported between the two factions. The Hadi government resigned back in January after the Houthis had taken over the capital city of Sana'a. The Saudis attacked Yemen in March, demanding the Hadi forces be reinstalled. After 3 months of war, however, there is no sign of this happening, and the Houthis still control most of the country. The peace talks got off to a bad start when the Hadi faction demanded that the Houthis surrender every city in the country as a condition of direct talks. Very little has come of the peace talks, however, and the fight is probably going to be the most noteworthy thing that's happened. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. All of your funds on Coinbase are safe, with approximately 90% of customer funds being stored offline, and all wallets are stored using AES 256 encryption. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports the Federal Communications Commission on Thursday voted in favor of covering broadband internet access for low-income households with a telephone subsidy program it has offered for 30 years. Three of the five members of the FCC voted in favor of reforming the program called Lifeline to include web access. Established in 1985, the Lifeline program has provided qualifying low-income Americans with a $9.25 per month subsidy towards phone service. Thursday's vote favors expanding it to include broadband internet, though the final structure of what that may look like is yet to be determined. Expanding the program still needs further government approval, where there is opposition to the expansion proposal. Some critics believe the $2 billion per year Lifeline program is already rife with abuses and fraud, and that the existing program should be fixed before it should be expanded. One Republican commissioner said in a report by The Hill, "We still have a long way to go if we are going to fix this program. Waste, fraud, and abuse are still rampant." In a news release Thursday, however, the FCC indicated that abuses of Lifeline have largely been eliminated and that further reforms are being developed to make sure that the program is helping the poor it's designed to help.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the U.S. Supreme Court on Thursday unanimously reinstated an Ohio man's conviction for beating his girlfriend's children after he sent her thousands of miles away to engage in prostitution. The nine justices rejected the arguments made by defendant Darius Clark that testimony given during trial by preschool teachers who talked to one of the victims, his girlfriend's three-year-old son, should have been disallowed. The testimony in question, in which the teacher pressed the boy on injuries they had noticed, did not violate Clark's rights under the U.S. Constitution's Sixth Amendment to confront his accusers, according to the court. Clark was convicted of abusing the three-year-old boy and the boy's 18-month-old sister. He was sentenced to 28 years in prison, but appeals court threw out the conviction, saying the teacher's testimony at trial was impermissible evidence. Teachers at the boy's preschool noticed what appeared to be injuries, and during trial, the teachers testified about the conversations they had with the boy. Justice Samuel Alito, writing on behalf of the court, wrote that the statements were admissible at trial because the teachers were not soliciting the information with the intent of using it as evidence. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to members of the 1998 University of Virginia graduating class, Governor Jim Gilmore's commencement speech to them continues to be a deep well of wisdom and guidance even 15 years after it was delivered. Classmates confirmed that while friends at other universities heard from such figures as Jimmy Carter, Kurt Vonnegut, and the Dalai Lama, the inspirational words of Virginia's 68th governor continues to profoundly inform their lives and actions.
Whenever I face a dark moment in my life, I just think back to Governor Gilmore's speech, and it almost instantly puts things back into perspective. It's like he said, go forward and be successful and achieve your hopes and dreams and aspirations. All I can say is I hope I've lived up to that incredible lesson.
And in local news, a five-year-old figures he has about a year left of peeing at urinals with his pants all the way down. In other news, using the amount of toothpaste shown in commercials is a disgusting experience. A grizzled proofreader has seen it written both ways, and a cackling Warren Buffett burns his entire fortune in front of the nation.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got all kinds of interesting stuff to talk with you about tonight. Joining you in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
Cecilyn.
And Daryl.
And so coming up, Cecilyn, you and I were at the Shire Dude trial this week, or what would have been a trial.
The would-be trial.
What we were hoping was going to be a trial, and we can talk more about what exactly happened there here in a little bit. And then, Daryl, you've got an update on the Ross Ulbricht case, sort of. One of the related stories to the case that may actually have a real impact on the appeal, hopefully.
Yes.
That's going to be real big news. I want to start with that here tonight, but also want to invite you to join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Plus, coming up, Kim Jong-un says he has created the cure for MERS, AIDS, and Ebola, and I think maybe a few other things. So we'll get into that because that's apparently a real story. We were checking today, Daryl. You were doing a lot of digging to see if this was a real story.
I was doing a lot of digging because as soon as you told me this, I said, oh, this has to be that same BS like North Korea landed on the sun, which came out from some parody satire website, and like CNN picked this thing up and ran with it, saying that North Korean state media claimed that they landed astronauts on the sun.
That's like legit liar, liar, pants on fire.
Right. But because people just want to laugh at North Korea,
they believe
they're willing to believe that North Korean state media said anything.
Well, there are a lot of ridiculous things that come out of North Korea. There's no doubt about that. So I can understand why people would fall into that trap. But there were some really ridiculous things in that Sun story that should have made it obvious that it wasn't
they landed
real.
At 3 o'clock in the morning so that it would be dark.
And when I say this story is real, what I mean is it seems to be something that North Korea has put out there. Not that I believe that they've actually created a cure for MERS, Ebola, right. SARS, and AIDS.
The claim coming from North Korean state media appears to be real.
Meaning that they actually did make the claim, not that the claim itself is true.
Yes.
And remember, for those of you who haven't seen, we might as well start with this one. We'll get to Ulbricht here in a moment. But for those of you who haven't seen any of the documentary work that's been done about North Korea, it's fascinating stuff. Vice.com has like three really good ones. There was another one I've
there
seen.
There was a National, I think it was National Geographic.
I haven't seen that one yet,
with
but it's
Lisa Ling
really
from probably 15, almost 20 years ago,
right.
Where she went in with a team of medical missionaries. And they got to actually go visit the apartment of one of the people that was getting cataract surgery. And all of the pictures and photographs and paintings inside the apartment were pictures and photos of Dear Leader and his family.
Oh, yeah.
And
it would have been
so
in big trouble if they didn't have those up, I imagine.
They asked the question, which one is your favorite? And the response was, oh, they're all my favorite. There was a question of, can Dear Leader do anything wrong? And this was when it was Kim Jong-il, not Kim Jong-un.
Right.
And the question was, can Dear Leader do anything wrong? The response was, I don't understand the question.
Wow, does not compute.
Yes.
It's not within their paradigm.
Like, they understood the concept of right and wrong, can somebody do wrong, but they did not comprehend, can Dear Leader do anything wrong?
Right.
That's some like big time Stockholm syndrome.
Yes.
Oh, yes. And well, of course, maybe, right? Like, you don't know whether the person's just putting on an act.
Right. And okay? that was basically the ultimate conclusion, because they recorded all of these people getting the bandages taken off of their eyes after the cataract surgery. And there was a big, giant picture of Dear Leader, and they went up and they were praying to Dear Leader. Thank you, Dear Leader, for giving me my sight back. I will work so much harder in the salt mines to please you. Thank you, thank you. And Lisa Ling, doing the commentary voiceover narration, said, at some point it was difficult to tell if these people were being sincere or if they were just putting on a show because they feared not
repercussions.
Being seen as being sincere.
Yeah, so it's hard to know.
But at some point it doesn't really matter because they were still complying with whatever was being asked.
You'd do whatever you needed to do to get your cataract surgery in North Korea as well, I suspect. Right? So
do whatever you have to do not to get killed.
Yeah, exactly. So here's the story from TheGuardian.com. North Korea says it has succeeded where the greatest minds in science have failed. The authoritarian, impoverished nation announced it has a drug that can prevent and cure MERS, Ebola, SARS, and AIDS. The official Korean Central News Agency said scientists developed Kumdang 2 from ginseng grown from fertilizer mixed with rare earth elements and micro quantities of gold and platinum, according to its website, kumdang2.com. I'm shocked that they even have a website. I mean, if you've ever tried to find North Korean websites, the only one that I've ever seen is the Central News Agency website, which looks like it was last updated as far as the guts of the site, as you know, the tech behind the site. It looks like it was last updated in 1998. They still put new items on there, but it had a real old kind of feel to it.
Did it look like the old GeoCities?
Maybe a little worse than that. It's been a while since I've laid eyes on it.
Does it have multicolored font with a really hard background to read?
With flashing,
and yeah. Little dancing things.
I don't know.
Place.
Maybe we can pull it up here and we'll
dancing
see.
Dancing Kims on the side.
We'll see if they've done an update. But apparently they've launched a website for Kumdang, KUMDANG, the number 2.com. Quote. This is their release from the Korean Central News Agency. Malicious virus infections like SARS, Ebola, and MERS are diseases that are related to immune systems, so they can be easily treated by Kumdang 2 injection drug, which is a strong immune reviver. The secretive state did not provide proof, and the claim is likely to provoke widespread skepticism. North Korea shut out foreign tourists for 6 months with some of the world's strictest Ebola controls, even though no cases of the disease were reported anywhere near the country before lifting the restrictions earlier this year. According to the World Health Organization, it's believed to be struggling to combat diseases such as tuberculosis and respiratory infections are among its most common causes of death. North Korea trumpeted the same drug during deadly bird flu outbreaks in 2006 and 2013. According to the pro-North Korea website Minjok Tongshin, the drug was originally produced in 1996. But is it just now that they determined that this drug that's been around for nearly two decades can cure SARS, Ebola, MERS, and AIDS?
It can cure everything. That's like all the big things.
It truly is a wonder drug. And the thing that you'll see, at least according to them, the thing you'll see them do is they'll claim that it was Kim Jong-un who actually designed the drug. Now, they don't say that here in the Guardian, but this is the kind of mentality that they have over there, sort of like you were saying, Daryl, where people were worshiping him as though he were the one who provided them with sight.
Right.
As though he were the one who, you know, designed the operation that they went through or something like that.
Well, because through Dear Leader, everything is possible.
All right, exactly. And so there was a Vice documentary where they actually went into a gym, and it was like, you know, Korean National Gym or something like that. And Kim Jong-il, I think, was in charge at the time. Or was it Un? I don't recall. But anyway, one of the Kims.
I think it was Un because it's when Dennis Rodman went over and they played basketball.
I get my Uns and my Uns confused all the time.
Un is the chubby boy. He looks like he's
the
more
only
than
fat
anyone
kid
in the whole
in the entire country.
So he had put his seal of approval on certain exercise equipment, and he had also designed the official North Korean
exercise regimen.
And so, you know, some people could go in and use unapproved equipment by Kim Jong-un, but obviously there were, you know, there was waiting in lines at the equipment that was blessed by him, essentially. And so, you know, he is generally revered as this godlike man. And so it wouldn't surprise me if they were promoting the idea that it was he who created this.
Do you want to hear the dosing treatment according to the website, akumdang2.com?
I would love to hear about that, but we're going to come back and do that here in a moment. The North Korea claims, by the way, come as a rival South Korea fights an outbreak of MERS that has killed 24 people and sickened more than 160 since last month. There is no vaccine for the disease, and we'll find out about, what was it, dosing instructions?
Yes.
For Kumdang 2. 2. We'll get back to that here in moments. 855-450-FREE. I bet you're just lining up out there to get a trip to North Korea and try this experimental technology. It's Free Talk Live. We'll return with more on the Olbricht trial as well. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com. SupernaturalSilver.com and use the promo code Silver2015 for 30% off of your entire order and give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippie!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Woo! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are 1, share 1 episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live. We'll talk about a little bit more about this North Korean claim that they have found the cure for SARS, Ebola, MERS, as well as AIDS.
They invented it back in 1989, apparently. Really? but they are just now figuring out all of the things that it cures. Their sure. website, the Kumdang 2 website, has not been updated in at least 3 years. Because it says, over the last 23 years since May of 1989, and that would be 3 years ago. So they've not updated the website in quite a while.
Let's talk more about that coming up here. I want to let you know about ProXPN first. That's a good way to protect yourself online from criminals that might want to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets or your very own internet service provider that may be saving your surfing history. In fact, they might be keeping those logs for several years in some cases. You can stop that from happening by encrypting your data connection with ProXPN. Just go and download their app. It's free. You can get started right now over at proxpn.com/FTL. Whether you're on Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, or Linux, they can get you connected and encrypted, which means no more prying and spying. ProXPN.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade to their premium account, you can use code FTL50. You'll save 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with code FTL50. It breaks down to about $5 per month. And by the way, that's good for the lifetime of the account. So when you're ready to upgrade, or not upgrade, when you're ready to renew for year number two, you'll get the same awesome discount at proxpn.com/FTL. Plus, with the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits, and you get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. So go to proxpn.com/FTL and use promo code FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. It's proxpn.com/FTL. So, Daryl, you've been doing a little digging on this claimed cure-all, basically, from North Korea, making the claim that it can cure MERS, Ebola, SARS, and AIDS. And this is Kumdang 2, which has been around for more than two decades.
Yes. And according to the website, before I get into the dosage, they have a much longer list of diseases and illnesses that it treats. So I'm not going to read the whole thing. I'm just going to read some of the ones that I find the most interesting.
All right, please.
Allergic skin disease, cosmetic effects, diabetes, different kinds of inflammation, fever for unknown reasons, disorders before and after childbirth, drug addiction, epidemic diseases such as bird flu, new flu, and AIDS, gastric hemorrhage, heart disease,
so hold on,
arthritis,
So
liver
says,
disorder caused by alcohol.
So it's...
It literally cures everything.
It's going to repair...
Pancreatitis.
It's going to repair your liver.
Epilepsy and spontaneous gangrene.
But it listed AIDS in that list, and this news story is making it sound like they're just now coming out with information, with a claim that it will cure AIDS. So
right. They also claim that it treats various cancers and venereal disease, as well as hepatitis.
It truly is... a cure-all.
And tuberculosis.
Praise dear leader.
And the dosage does not change depending on
what
illness you have.
Tell me about that.
The opinions of... Wait, no, this is under certificates. Dosing. The basic administration of Kumdang 2 injection is simply on the first day, apply 1 to 2 ampules. And I'm not sure how much that is, but it's some... measuring dose of something.
It's whatever it comes in, I think. They come in some injectors or whatever.
Okay, 1 to 2 ampules. And from the second day, depending on the patient's response, increase every day its each time dose by 1 ampule, getting them 1 to 2 times daily with an interval of 1 to 2 days on every 5th day.
An ampule is a sealed glass capsule containing a liquid, especially a measured quantity, ready for injecting. So inject with 1, and then if it doesn't clear up the next day...
It says 1 to 2, and then on the second day, depending on the response, increase, skip every 5th day. Skip either 1 or 2 days every 5th day. After the 10th day, including the days of interval, get 7 to 8 ampules each time, 2 to 3 times daily.
Whoa.
For 2 to 3 days, then suspend the injection. And later, depending on the development of cure, resume the injection. This method is oriented from the mechanism of applying a heavy strike upon the disease after the patient's body is acclimated to the injection. In case of emergency, by injecting it every 4 to 6 hours, 5 to 8 ampules each time, we could save
this
many dying patients.
This is a lot of
patients.
Injecting. I'd just like to say, I mean, I don't have a problem with needles, but some people certainly do, and this is a lot of poking.
Yes.
Maybe they should just do a transplant and take out all of your blood and just
and put in
and just fill it with this stuff. Because it sounds like it's magic.
Yes. We can save many dying patients if the patient with no critical severity got from the first day as many as 6 to 8 ampules each time. They might experience overburden at the heart, indigestion, and other heavy healing responses while getting little effects on the treatment.
It's okay. Your heart's burning because you're actually healing. That's the indicator that
on the other
you're
hand,
getting
so,
better.
Well, what they're
it's
saying
the burning
here,
feeling of dear leader's love.
If you overdose on Kumdang 2, then you might have, overburden of the heart.
Right.
Indigestion and other heavy healing responses. On the other hand, injection of only 1 to 2 ampules every day for a very long period would result in the waste of the medication and a failure to obtain the desired effect.
So you have to be very, very careful to take the dosage in the way that is recommended. You don't want to stray outside of those parameters because then the healing abilities will be maybe nullified.
You either have overburden of the heart or you're wasting the medicine.
I love how side effects have become heavy healing.
That's an interesting marketing promo there.
Yeah, and I'm guessing that something is lost in translation here from Korean to English.
So I wonder what this stuff costs. I mean, does it have an order form or whatever? Or there was a different website that you'd have to go to, right? Some Russian.
Yeah, so they have on there where to buy, and it takes you to something that's written in Russian. Mm-hmm. And thanks to Google Translate, I found out that it says this product can be purchased at the online store KoreaBud.com. The goods are delivered worldwide, possible cooperation. Our dealers in the Russian Federation, and then there's a telephone number. There's actually two telephone numbers, both in Russia. Moscow supplies certified. Beware of imitations. Buy Kumdang 2 injections only from authorized distributors and dealers.
You know, I wonder how many people take this seriously outside of North Korea. I mean, are there poor, sick people out there who are seeing these headlines now and actually feeling like they have a chance that, you know, they could cure AIDS or SARS or MERS with this, that, you know, it's sort of leading them to this website in a legitimate manner? Because obviously we're talking about this just sa-ha-ha, North Korea.
I think you can cure your hypochondria with this. But then again, you can cure hypochondria with placebo.
Wait a minute. Hypochondria, that's where people think they're always sick, right?
Yes.
I don't think you can cure hypochondria because those people tend to want attention, right? Like, that's why they keep
but
getting sick.
If you give somebody placebo and say, this will cure whatever's wrong with you, then they'll think that they're okay as long as they're taking their medicine.
But no, they'll keep coming up with new problems. That's sort of
not
what a hypochondriac does, right?
No, it's all in your brain. You think you need.
The pill is helping me.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Your thoughts on North Korea? You can certainly bring up anything you want. Plus, coming up, the latest on the Ross Ulbricht situation. This is Free Talk Live.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Don't worry about things you can't control. Isn't that what they always say? But it's about impossible to avoid worrying about what's going on these days. The government has used the war on guns, the war on drugs, and the war on terrorism to tear our Bill of Rights to shreds. But you can fight back. The 10th Amendment Center has proven it, racking up major victories. For example, when the U.S. government claimed authority in the NDAA to have the military kidnap and detain Americans without trial, the nullifiers got a law passed in California, declaring the state's refusal to ever participate in any such thing. Their latest project is offnow.org, nullifying the National Security Agency. They've already gotten model legislation introduced in California, Arizona, Oklahoma, Missouri, and Kansas, meant to limit the power of the NSA to spy on Americans in those states. We'd be fools to wait around for the U.S. Congress or courts to roll back Big Brother. Our best chance is nullification and interposition on the state level. Go to offnow.org, print out that model legislation, and get to work nullifying the NSA. The hero Edward Snowden has risked everything to give us this chance. Let's take it. Offnow.org.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program. You may take control of the airwaves here and bring up whatever's on your mind. Coming up, the Shire Dude. What was supposed to be a trial, Cecilyn and I will talk about that because we were both in attendance, as were a number of other activists. Was very good attendance at this middle of the day affair in Manchester earlier this week. We'll talk about that. Also, the latest on Ross Ulbricht and what is a pretty important development in the sort of one of the tangentially related cases that could have a major effect on his appeal.
I don't know if tangentially related is the correct
term. How about
just
related?
It's directly related.
Yeah. I agree with you. I shouldn't have used that term. So we'll get into that here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. The Skype username is lrn.fm. Now, this week, Peacekeeper is launching an Indiegogo campaign for Peacekeeper 2.0. Last year, as you may recall, they released Peacekeeper 1.0, and as the world's first alternative to dialing 911, it was a hit. But there were some problems, limited features, persistent bugs, and a lack of a real network. They've spent the last 6 months learning from the first app, and they've learned what doesn't work and what does work and how to build on it. Peacekeeper 2.0 has the potential to be world-changing. They're creating new features like a verified network of peacekeepers that you can call in an emergency. No longer will you have to just rely on your groups and alliances. Now every peacekeeper in the area is a potential ally. They're hiring a new developer to create a powerful bug-free system and renovating their marketing and hoping they can bring in 100,000 users next year and show the state what real change looks like. They need your help. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement. It's a revolutionary system designed to challenge the status quo. It's a tool that will allow ordinary people like you to stand up and be heroes. It's a fast, flexible alert system that can help keep you safe better than dialing 911. Peacekeeper can change the world, and you can help by contributing to their Indiegogo campaign today. Just visit this website, and it'll forward you to the proper Indiegogo link. It's PK, like Peacekeeper, pk.freetalklive.com. If you want to see Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means, contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today. And of course, there's perks involved in this. pk.freetalklive.com. We're talking about the North Korean claim that they've got an amazing wonder drug made out of ginseng and some secret ingredients.
And platinum and gold, apparently.
Micro amounts. Micro.
Right.
Just and a little.
That will cure pretty much everything. Daryl, you went through a laundry list of problems that people might have on the website Kumdang 2, was it?
Kumdang2.com.
It's K-U-M-D-A-N-G and the number 2.com.
No dash, no hyphens,
I mean,
nothing.
If you have a hiccup, you got a bout of the hiccups. Was we'll that take in care there? Of that. I'm just making things up at this point. You got some rash on your feet. It'll handle that. It might kill you.
I bet you if you emailed them and asked if you could clear up hiccups, they'd probably come back with a yes. Would
be probably. I mean, after they updated their website that's, you know, at least 3 years old, they might get back to me.
And by the way, this is an injectable drug. You cannot take this drug without injecting it, and that's a pretty serious way to get something into your body.
You can do it either intravenously or intramuscularly.
Well, that's just wonderful.
Meaning that you can either put it straight into the vein or just into like a blob of muscle.
Wow. So you can share your thoughts here. North Korea is a fascinating place. I don't know if there's much else to say about this, but maybe there's some other news in North Korea that you want to share. You're welcome to join us here at toll-free at 855-450-FREE. And, of course, join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So the Ross Ulbricht trial. For those who don't know, Cecilyn, how would you explain to somebody who's never heard anything about Ross Ulbricht who he is?
So there's this guy, and he made a website. On the black net or the dark net, you know, that can't be tracked by government agencies, whatnot. And some people used his website to sell things. Some of those things, some people may call illegal.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
like drugs.
Like drugs or other items. And so they arrested him and they put him in jail for life.
That's a pretty good summary. Yeah. These underground dark net markets, the Silk Road was the one that he created, and it was the most infamous of all. Of course, the FBI,
first of its kind.
Yeah. The FBI managed to shut down Silk Road 1 and 2, but there are now more than a dozen other sites in operation, and the black net or the dark net or whatever you call it is as popular as it has ever been, if not more so. So ultimately, all of the attacks on these various different marketplaces have done nothing but spread a more diverse group of marketplaces.
Because when you tell someone that they can't do something, all they're going to want to do is do it.
And there certainly is a desire and a demand in the market for drugs and other things that you normally can't buy legally. And so as long as the demand is out there, people will fill that demand. Daryl, you've got an update on this situation involving the DEA agent and Secret Service agent who have been charged with multiple felony counts in regards to essentially stealing money from Ross Ulbricht, or stealing from the government, ultimately, is the way the government is seeing
right.
it, right? Because they confiscated Ross Ulbricht's Bitcoin, and these guys were involved in that. So, and I'm summarizing the story here. These guys were involved in the investigation, in the confiscation, and were trying to essentially funnel money to themselves, as well as do other things like essentially try to extort from Ross
right.
as well.
And convince Ross that he needs to kill people that didn't actually exist or do the things that they alleged that the person did. The story here comes from Business Insider. And they began, Ross Ulbricht, the convicted mastermind behind Silk Road, the world's largest online narcotics emporium, won't be the only person nabbed because of his or her involvement with the site. Former U.S. Secret Service agent Sean Bridges will plead guilty to charges connected to the case, including money laundering and obstruction of justice charges. Bridges had been part of the Baltimore Silk Road Task Force, known as SA Force, a group charged with tracking down Ulbricht, who went by the handle Dread Pirate Roberts.
On the team with Bridges was DEA agent Karl Mark Force IV, who is also facing criminal charges.
Officer Force. That's that guy's name.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Force is charged with extorting Albrecht, as well as wire fraud, theft of government property, money laundering, and conflict of interest. Over the course of the investigation, Bridges diverted to a personal account more than $800,000 in Bitcoin acquired during his investigation.
Wow.
He is expected to formally plead guilty later this year to the money laundering and obstruction charge. It is unknown what type of sentence he will receive.
It will be much less than Ross's sentence, I predict.
Of course, because whenever you comply and do what they say, they go lenient on you.
Right. It didn't, I just as an example, and also because he's one of the government's people, they'll probably go more lenient on him because of that as well.
Right.
I just saw some headline about a soldier who murdered somebody over in the Middle East, and he has been given time served.
Oh, yeah. The guy had the trial, I believe, out in California. Just wound up, that trial ended, and yeah, jury gave him time served.
Yeah.
Yes, the government people do tend to get a better shake of the stick unless you go up against the government in some way, form, or fashion, like Snowden.
Yeah, exactly. So, right. Tell me more.
The lawyer for Mr. Bridges told the Associated Press, Mr. Bridges accepts complete responsibility. He's regretted his actions from the start.
What? He feels from the bad, start. Guys.
From
he
the start.
Bad. From the start of the prosecution.
Cut him a break, probably. Guys. He feels bad. You're hurting his feels.
Yeah, he should feel bad. He got caught.
He resigned from his post at the Secret Service on March 18th after learning that he was subject to an investigation. Mm. He later surrendered to the authorities in San Francisco and was released on bail several days later. The story behind how Force and Bridges became involved in their illegal activities is almost as strange as that of Albrecht. While undercover on Silk Road as Knob, French Maid, and later Death from Above, Force allegedly sold information to Albrecht illegally about the government's investigation and siphoned the payments into his own personal account. Force allegedly extorted enough money to pay off his mortgage, repay a $22,000 government loan, wire $235 to an offshore account in Panama, invest tens of thousands of dollars in real estate and stocks.
Hold that thought. We'll come back with more here because I think there's an aspect of this that's very interesting about Force, the other guy. Now, Force hasn't yet pled guilty.
Right.
He's the one who's accused of doing the most in this Albrecht scam, this scandal, if you will. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Quantum Life, it's year 2523. There are colonies on Venus, Mars, and Mercury. People travel in bubbles, fly at hyperspeed, with brain implants and artificial gravity. A scientific genius and his clever assistant set out on an adventure through the solar system. Find the key to access new frontiers and save liberty. QuantumVibe.com from Big Head Press.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources.
We don't just sell the products, we live it.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, you may join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE, and you can join us via Skype at Skype username LRN.FM. Just send a contact request along. We will approve it as soon as we notice it come in. And then once you're approved, it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype about, again, whatever's on your mind. We're talking about the Ross Ulbricht trial and the related issues of these DEA and Secret Service agents, one of whom has now pled guilty to multiple felony counts, I believe, of basically being a scumbag and essentially extracting money from Ross Ulbricht and or other things. We'll get back into the story. Also want to invite you to our website at freetalklive.com. You can actually create the content there by submitting news items, YouTube videos, fun stuff, whatever you think's cool, whatever you want our listeners to see and appreciate. You submit it there to the front page of the site via our Reddit-based system, and other listeners can vote up or down on whether they like or dislike your suggestion. So please go get interactive. It's free over at freetalklive.com. So, Daryl, you're talking about the Secret Service agent. There was a Secret Service agent and a DEA agent who essentially worked to steal money from the Silk Road website, to extract money from Ross through lying to him and trying to, or extract, I should clarify, extract money from Dread Pirate Roberts. Because I think there's an important point here, and that is that Ross Ulbricht's original claim, when they opened the attorney did opening statements, was that Ross, yes, he designed the Silk Road, this infamous underground black marketplace online. Yes, he did design it. Yes, he was the first operator of the website, but that he at some point gave up operation of the site to someone else, and then later was somehow brought back in order to go down as Dread Pirate Roberts, in that the suggestion was that the operator that he had originally handed it off to somehow got wind, perhaps from this DEA agent or Secret Service person, got wind that a raid was imminent, and or that they were under serious investigation, and that dude then bailed, somehow enticing Ross to come back in and take over the site again, and then so Ross went down with the ship, so to speak. At least that's the narrative of the defense. Unfortunately, the defense was not able to actually present the story as to how all that supposedly happened.
Right, and they weren't allowed to bring up this in court either.
Of the corruption, you mean?
Right. Right. Because, well, the government is doing an investigation. You can't bring up things about an investigation that's currently ongoing, so you're guilty anyway.
So the appeal is in for Ross Ulbricht, and hopefully this revelation that these two agents were scumbags is going to help him in his appeal, especially since one has already pleaded guilty.
Right.
And that likely means that he has rolled on the other guy if he knows anything about the DEA agent, Mr. Force, and what it was that he was up to. And I don't know what interaction the two of them had together. But if he does know anything, I imagine he is singing like a canary.
After I finish with this article, there is a statement from Ross's attorney that was posted on the Free Ross Facebook page that I'll get to. The story here from Business Insider continues. It says, in January 2013, $820,000 worth of Bitcoin were stolen from the Silk Road. A theft that Ulbricht traced back to the account of Silk Road employee Curtis Green, although DPR allegedly hired Knob, thinking he was a hitman to kill Green for stealing.
Just to clarify, Knob was also known as Agent Force.
He
was undercover on the website, masquerading as though he was a drug dealer.
So,
and actually probably did sell drugs in order to get the cred that he needed to eventually end up taking over as an administrator on the
right. So Green was hired to wind up getting killed by Knob. Unbeknownst to Ross Ulbricht, Green gave up his admin stuff to Knob just a couple hours before the money was stolen. So the whole thing was a ruse from the get-go.
So meaning that the administrator had gotten busted, right? The what was his name?
Curtis Green.
He had gotten popped, and I forget what the story was behind how that happened, but I think he was selling drugs and somehow somebody opened a package and it somehow led back to him. Anyway, they busted him somehow long before the site itself was taken down, and he turned over his administrative access as Curtis Green or whatever his online name was to this agent.
Right.
And then what happened with the money, and when did it
This was just a couple hours before the agent convinced Ross to put a hit out on Curtis Green.
Mm-hmm.
So Curtis Green no longer had admin privileges to the site when $820,000 worth of Bitcoin got siphoned. But
how the hell does that happen without admin privileges? I'm missing something.
Okay, let's pretend for a second, Ian, that you're Curtis Green.
Okay.
You give me access to your account.
And you're the DEA agent.
I'm the DEA agent. You wash your hands. I no longer have access. You're running my account now.
Mm-hmm.
You are out of the picture. 3 hours later, I remove money using the account that you just gave me access to.
And you still had administrative access at that time.
I'm the DEA agent.
Right.
I have access. You do not.
Correct.
But I've got access to your account because you gave me access to your account.
Mm-hmm.
You've walked away. I tell Ross Ulbricht, hey, Curtis Green just stole $820,000 from you. You should probably put a hit out on him. I know a guy.
I see. You told Ross that through your other account, the Knob account or whatever.
Yes.
Okay.
So Bridges and Force let DPR believe that Green had actually stolen the funds.
Mm-hmm.
Unbeknownst to DPR, Green actually forfeited his admin account to Bridges hours before the theft occurred. Nevertheless, Bridges allegedly staged Green's murder with Force's help, sending, quote, proof of death to DPR, and that was later used against Ulbricht. And again, this is part of that unfiled charges stuff that's still hanging in Baltimore.
Right. So for those that aren't aware, Ross Ulbricht was essentially tarnished with the idea that he was a murderer. When he was first arrested, the FBI made statements about how he was allegedly involved in these hitmen for hire plots. And now what we're seeing is that at least this one plot was a total setup from the corrupt DEA and Secret Service agents who are working together to extort money from Dread Pirate Roberts. And so this is evidence that, first of all, it's evidence that the whole thing was a scam in the first place, the idea of, you know, putting a hit out on somebody. The entire thing was manufactured from the get-go. But the one thing that's still not clear is who Dread Pirate Roberts was at the time that these people were communicating with him or her.
And there was
we don't know if it was Ross Ulbricht.
There was one of the agents that testified during the trial that he thought it was Mark Karpeles from Mt. Gox.
That's right.
And then 3 days later, the judge tells the jury, hey, forget everything that you heard the first 3 days of the trial because it's all speculation.
Yes. So if the story is true that Ross Ulbricht's attorney told that Ross handed off control of the site, then it may not have even been Ross who ordered the hit, who
right.
was successfully extorted from. I mean, the idea that Ross would do something like that was shocking to a lot of people, given that he is kind of like a peace-oriented libertarian type. I mean, he was recommending libertarian books to people on the Silk Road forums. He had like a Dread Pirate Roberts reading club, and this guy was supposedly a very, you know, principled guy who, in theory, did not believe in initiation of force. Now, of course, you could claim that it wasn't initiatory force because, well, you know, he put hits out on people who were trying to extort money from him. And so, therefore, maybe that was – there's a libertarian argument that that was actually self-defense.
Right. So
convince a jury.
By late January of 2013, Bridges had transferred all of the stolen Bitcoin into the now-defunct exchange, Mt. Gox, according to the Justice Department. By the end of May, the criminal complaint alleges that $820,000 had been wired from Bridges' Mt. Gox account to the bank account of Quantum International Investments, LLC, a dummy corporation he set up in February to hide the stolen money.
Hmm.
In addition, Bridges, quote, without authority, developed additional online personas and engaged in a broad range of illegal activities calculated to bring him personal financial gain.
Wow. Bridges did. Bridges did.
Yes.
Interesting. Okay. When I first read about these two, the Mark Force and Bridges, the guy who's now pled guilty, I got the impression that Bridges wasn't quite as involved as Force in a lot of this extortion, but it sounds like they were working intimately together.
That's what it sounds like to me, and I think they pretty much have the same charges. I think Force might have one or two more.
Hmm.
And my guess is with this plea deal that Bridges is going to take, he's not actually signed it yet.
Yep.
He's just said, I'm going to plead. They're probably going to wind up dropping a couple more of these charges and let him off with a slap on the wrist. And his case is going through the Northern District of California, not through New York.
Well, if he takes the plea in this case, it's guilty. And that means that Ross might have a better chance with his appeal. And it also means that other agent, the DEA guy, is probably going to go down pretty hard. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up. Hour 2's on the way.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. ZOG.ninja. Code FTL.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, June 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.19 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,202 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $249. Antiwar.com reports, the first 3 days of the Yemen peace talks in Geneva were pretty unproductive, but at least no one got hit. The situation took a turn for the worse on Thursday when the Houthis' attempt to hold a press event was attacked by supporters of the Hadi faction. Houthi delegate Hamza al-Houthi was delivering his address to the assembled media when one of the Hadi delegates rushed the stage and threw a shoe at him. Shoes started flying back and forth despite Houthi's attempt to keep talking and ignore the disruption, and before long, fistfights were reported between the two factions. The Hadi government resigned back in January after the Houthis had taken over the capital city of Sana'a. The Saudis attacked Yemen in March, demanding the Hadi forces be reinstalled. After 3 months of war, however, there is no sign of this happening, and the Houthis still control most of the country. The peace talks got off to a bad start when the Hadi faction demanded that the Houthis surrender every city in the country as a condition of direct talks. Very little has come of the peace talks, however, and the fight is probably going to be the most noteworthy thing that's happened.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. All of your funds on Coinbase are safe, with approximately 90% of customer funds being stored offline, and all wallets are stored using AES 256 encryption. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com.
UPI reports the Federal Communications Commission on Thursday voted in favor of covering broadband internet access for low-income households with a telephone subsidy program it has offered for 30 years. Three of the five members of the FCC voted in favor of reforming the program called Lifeline to include web access. Established in 1985, the Lifeline program has provided qualifying low-income Americans with a $9.25 per month subsidy towards phone service. Thursday's vote favors expanding it to include broadband internet, though the final structure of what that may look like is yet to be determined. Expanding the program still needs further government approval, where there is opposition to the expansion proposal. Some critics believe the $2 billion per year Lifeline program is already rife with abuses and fraud, and that the existing program should be fixed before it should be expanded. One Republican commissioner said in a report by The Hill, "We still have a long way to go if we are going to fix this program. Waste, fraud, and abuse are still rampant." In a news release Thursday, however, the FCC indicated that abuses of Lifeline have largely been eliminated and that further reforms are being developed to make sure that the program is helping the poor it's designed to help.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the U.S. Supreme Court on Thursday unanimously reinstated an Ohio man's conviction for beating his girlfriend's children after he sent her thousands of miles away to engage in prostitution. The nine justices rejected the arguments made by defendant Darius Clark that testimony given during trial by preschool teachers who talked to one of the victims, his girlfriend's three-year-old son, should have been disallowed. The testimony in question, in which the teacher pressed the boy on injuries they had noticed, did not violate Clark's rights under the U.S. Constitution's Sixth Amendment to confront his accusers, according to the court. Clark was convicted of abusing the three-year-old boy and the boy's 18-month-old sister. He was sentenced to 28 years in prison, but appeals court threw out the conviction, saying the teacher's testimony at trial was impermissible evidence. Teachers at the boys' preschool noticed what appeared to be injuries, and during trial, the teachers testified about the conversations they had with the boy. Justice Samuel Alito, writing on behalf of the court, wrote that the statements were admissible at trial because the teachers were not soliciting the information with the intent of using it as evidence. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Congress today passed a landmark Social Security reform bill they estimate could save the troubled program billions. The so-called Grab Life by the Balls bill includes provisions to cut the cost of cigarettes in half, outlaws helmets, and adjusts the CDC's recommended amount of sleep from 8 hours a night to when you're dead. The bill's short-term initiatives aim to immediately cut Social Security costs in half by replacing senior citizens' monthly checks with vouchers for grain alcohol and extreme sports.
I got this coupon to motocross over a canyon. Better do my part to help the deficit.
Supporters in Congress say the cost will be offset by the so-called pussy tax on products such as sweaters, vegetables, hand soap, and flu shots.
America, would you rather die old, broke, and forgotten, or die a motherfucking legend?
The new program follows in the footsteps of the Life is a Cartoon Medicare campaign, which encourages seniors to run full speed off of cliffs and smoke sticks of dynamite.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free and join us here to bring up anything that you want. The us, by the way, includes me, Ian.
Cecilyn.
And Daryl.
And you, if you want to join us here. We've got Skype, Skype username tonight, lrn.fm. Just send a contact request first. If you've never done that before, then we'll approve it, and you'll be good to go on Skype from that point forward. Toll-free numbers are 855-450-FREE. Coming up, it was going to be the trial of Shire Dude this week, but it didn't turn out that way. We'll tell you more about what happened in court, because I don't think that's been discussed very much or in great detail yet, if it was even mentioned on this program. We'll get into that. I was there to witness it, as was Cecilyn. But first, Tom, in Nashua, New Hampshire, you're on Free Talk Live. Tom.
It's about the shooting down in South Carolina at that white church with a black roof. And the difference between what they're reporting, of course, and what's actually true, I'll get to that in a minute. But he was busted. That guy was busted in February for suboxone.
Yeah, I heard about that.
He was facing a felony charge, and they're making a big issue about how he shouldn't have been able to buy a gun when he had a felony charge. Well, excuse me, but if they minded their own business, maybe he would have died of an overdose, and he wouldn't have been out there shooting these people. Aren't we lucky to have these DEA bureaucrats and cops running around busting people? But
that's an interesting perspective, Tom. I can't say I've heard that one.
What is suboxone? I have never heard of this before.
It's some sort of drug Go ahead.
It's an opiate. It's kind of the same category as oxycodone. But I'd like to make a point here about the difference. Seems like I'm nitpicking. I'm calling it a white church with a black roof.
Do you mean it's painted white?
That's correct. Now, the point is,
I think by black church, they're referring to the fact that the majority of the attendees are black people.
Yeah, but they didn't say that. And what I'm getting at here is a different news story is talking about how in the Dominican Republic, they're deporting all these Haitians, but actually they're deporting Dominicans who are of Haitian ancestry. And there's a humongous difference between deporting somebody who may have come to the country 5 years ago illegally and somebody who's been born there who's like third generation and doesn't have birth certificates to prove that they've been living there all these years. And this is what's actually going on down in the Dominican Republic. And it could happen in the United States, too, because it was a constitutional amendment in the Dominican Republic that's allowing all of this to happen. It would be totally unconstitutional under the prior constitution. But what's going on there is that, see, and that's the big difference. It sounded like I was picking nits about the color of the church. The news headlines are talking about all these Haitians being deported, and it makes a big difference when they take a shortcut and call them Haitians. Some of these people went to go get their birth certificates, And the bureaucrats say, okay, well, yes, get in line with everybody else and we'll file it. And if they don't process their own work fast enough, these people missed the deadline that passed on Wednesday to file to get a permanent resident card. Isn't that nice?
So the people who are trying to stay here got their paperwork in on time, but the bureaucrats dealt with it too slowly, so they ended up getting deported. Is that what you're saying?
These people are facing deportation because they are trying to get their paperwork in order, but the bureaucrats did not process on their end.
And I miss what that has to do with the shooting in South Carolina, if you explain that. I missed that detail.
Okay, I'm talking about what it sounds like I'm picking nits and being too picky, calling it a black church, or the difference of calling it a white church with a black roof that a lot of black people go to. Speaking precisely is very important, because when you're talking about some cases, okay.
But like, what does that have to do with the Haitians being deported?
Because they're people that were born in the Dominican Republic,
uh-huh,
that are by birth Dominican citizens, but their grandparents may have been from Haiti. So they're being referred to as Haitian, but they themselves are not actually Haitian.
Now, this has nothing to do with the church shooting, is what you're saying. It's just a different story where you're talking about nitpicking.
It has to do with headlines that are misrepresenting facts.
I gotcha. Okay, so not really connected.
Speaking very precisely can often be very important, because there's a big difference between the common lies. Like, for your information, this country was founded as a democracy. No, it was not. And for your information,
but there's really no difference between democracy and republic in its operation, right? It's still just a group of men and women ruling over others. Thank you, Tom, for the call. I definitely appreciate kind of where he's coming from with, it's good to be specific, it's good to be accurate in the things that you say.
Right.
On the other hand, when you're writing headlines, you can only put so much information in there, right? Like, the longer the headline is, generally the worse it tends to be.
Right.
So,
if your headline is a full sentence, then
it's a problem.
It's a problem.
Titles aren't sentences anymore. They're clickbait. It's not, you know, what's actually going on. It's whatever's going to get the person to read it.
Most clickbait, I'm just going to break clickbait down of blank did blank. You won't believe what happened blank.
Yeah.
So it could be, it's like Mad Libs. Like, there's Mad Libs for clickbait. Ian went to court. You won't believe what happened at 2 minutes and 47 seconds.
Yeah, for sure.
He picked his nose, in case you're wondering. I watched.
Well, there's a lot of video of the Shire dude, what was supposed to be a trial. We can get into details on that. The video itself is not yet out. There are multiple camera angles that are going to need to be edited into a full package of, you know, that will represent what happened in court this week. You were not there, Daryl. You weren't able to.
I was not.
A different trial.
Were you sleepy?
You were getting work done, I think, is what it was.
That trial was on what, Wednesday? Tuesday?
Tuesday at 1.
I was working and then going to the gym and getting ready for Porkfest.
And we actually had a really good turnout. I wasn't so sure. It was in the middle of the day, and I'm thinking, maybe this isn't. I don't know how well promoted it was. Turns out, what was it, 8 to plus maybe more than 8 people were there? It seemed 8 to 10.
It was about a dozen.
A dozen?
About a dozen, yeah.
Yeah, so a good turnout. A couple of us came up from Keene. Derek J. and I came out there, and we brought our cameras. And, of course, Shire Dude had his camera as well and was doing some live streaming. So I guess there is the live stream version available out there somewhere. Is that at ShireDude.com?
Yes. It's on his Bamboozer, so you can go to ShireDude.com.
And link to that.
And, yeah, exactly.
Now, I don't know how good that came out or how much of it was streamed, because there was a lot that went on prior to the actual beginning of the hearing. That was really the most interesting part. The part where the judge was in the courtroom was not the most interesting. It was how the bailiffs were treating us and what was going on the outside, or rather outside of the court and also in the courtroom.
And this was in Manchester?
Correct. Manchester District Court was where this one was. And I actually hadn't been in Manchester's District Court for quite a while.
Since Kelly Voluntarius got arrested for writing in chalk.
Or was it Wes? I feel like it might have been Wes.
No, we went for a Deimos trial for the chalking thing. And Kelly chalked Free Adamo on the wall and got arrested, taken off the paddy wagon.
So is Manchester's district court not in the same building as the court with the mobile of the shredded constitution and declaration?
Different building,
correct.
Entirely different building.
Yeah. Okay.
So where do we start with this one, Cecilyn? Because it was a fairly lengthy afternoon. We thought it was going to begin at 1:15. Ultimately, the judge did not enter the chambers until – or enter the courtroom until 3 o'clock.
All right, so
I like to refer to it as the day no one showed up for their job.
Mm. So let me ask a couple of questions here.
Sure.
Because I know that when we went to Manchester Superior Court previously,
right,
Ian, you and I both have media registration with the state of New Hampshire's judicial system.
That's right.
And we have had problems in some of the courts around the state, Manchester Superior being one of them, where even though we showed the bailiffs the document from the state saying, "Your media," and showed them press badges, they still said, "You've got to go over there and fill out paper, and then the judge gets to determine if you get to use a camera."
No, no.
Did you have anything like that in the circuit or the district court in Manchester?
Sort of, yes.
There was similar.
Variant on that. So, and by the way, with this permission
slip. We also had the problem in Concord District Court a couple of years ago. Same sort of thing where we showed them the papers and they're like, "No, you must go over there and fill out a form and then the judge will decide whether or not you have the rights that have been bestowed upon you by being media."
Yes, I want to address that coming up here in moments, and we'll talk more about what happened with the Shire dude, what was supposed to be a trial for multiple parking tickets this week, and we'll come back with that. 855-450-FREE. Then coming up, seized Uber cars. It's Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. Simply Safe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, Simply Safe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it, and that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. Simply Safe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. Simply Safe. Go to simplysafedefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's simplysafedefense.com.
If you're looking for work, you know what I mean by elevator speech. It's the short version, saying just enough to make the listener want to listen more. Even if you're not a job seeker, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. So to cut through the clutter, choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Instead of saying, "due to the fact that," say, "because," and avoid mispronunciations. Say jewelry, not jewelry, which could offend. Undoubtedly, you don't want to say undoubtedly. And whatever you do, never use a preposition to end a sentence with. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. More about the Shire Dude trial, or what was expected to be a trial, turned out to just be a continuance. We'll explain how it got to that point, because there's a lot of really interesting and somewhat outrageous stuff that the bureaucrats at the courthouse did that Cecilyn and I were witness to. It is Ian, Cecilyn, and Daryl in the studio. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us, is 855-450-FREE. Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com get every day. Readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com are constantly provided the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. FreedomsPhoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com and get signed up there for their free daily dispatch. Once again, that's FreedomsPhoenix.com. So we were just discussing a moment ago the access, media access to the courts. You had asked a question about that, Daryl, because we've had Cecilyn.
Well, I was going to give you some backstory on this because Rob and Shire Dude actually did some preliminary stuff when they had the pretrial hearing, when Shire Dude met with the prosecutor to talk about the charges and to kind of give a plea and whatnot. Mm-hmm. They went in and talked to the bailiffs and talked to the court people and made sure that it'd be okay for Rob to actually record, and they're like, oh, well, yes, you're with Free Keen. Yes, we know all about you. Yes, yes, it's fine. And I actually made him up a little press badge. It says press. It has his picture and has freekeen.com on the bottom. And it's open doors for him. He just flashes it and he walks right in with his
camera. Well, Mr. Dude, welcome.
Well, no,
come on in.
No, Rob. I made one for Rob.
Oh, I thought you made one for Shire Dude, too.
No.
Why would you leave him out?
He doesn't need one yet.
But why not?
Because he hasn't recorded for Rob.
Oh.
Because okay. Rob is specifically has been recording for Shire Dude at these events.
Gotcha.
Yes.
So what you were asking about, Daryl, was the media access that in New Hampshire, the way it's supposed to work by Supreme Court order, essentially. The
yes.
Supreme Court has created these media access rules, basically.
That are voluntary. Well, the media registration form
voluntary.
Is voluntary.
Voluntary.
No, no, it is. It is. No, the media registration form is voluntary, and it's supposed to bypass the filing of request for the judge.
The idea
the rules
being
that, are not voluntary.
Okay, so the idea being that you can voluntarily get this media sort of approval by the Supreme Court, and then you don't have to fill out a form every time you go into a courthouse.
So fill out my magic piece of paper, and I won't give you a hard time.
In theory, that's what's supposed
theory,
to happen.
Yes.
But what Daryl was saying previously was at a different courthouse in Manchester.
Different court in Manchester, a court in Newport, a court in Concord. There have been problems.
Yeah, we don't have any problems with it in the courts here in Keene because we're pretty established there. But these bureaucrats have given us issues. So even though the courts have orders out that make it crystal clear that anybody with this media pass that flashes the media pass, basically, and it's a form from the court, from the Supreme Court that, you know, identifies the name of the organization and says that these people have the ability to come in without filling out your paperwork and asking for permission, that all you're supposed to have to do is just show the bailiff this form, and then the doors are supposed to open for you.
But it's legal land where the rules are made up
on the spot, usually.
And your rights don't matter.
Right, and
You say we don't have problems in Keene, but during the Robin Hood trial, we, or at least I had problems.
Oh.
Because remember, it was the first day of like what became a 3-day hearing on something. You set up the camera. You were one of the defendants. You set up the camera, then went and sat at the defense table.
Oh, yes.
And I stood up to operate the camera. And grumpy old Bailiff Tebow came over and starts yelling at me, and I'm holding up my media registration form. Yep. And he says, I don't want to see that. You need to sit down. I was like, but I've got media registration. Here's the form. I don't want to see it. Sit down. Sit down.
Was that recorded by any chance?
Yes, it was recorded.
That's good. A perfect impersonation of Tebow. I've had interactions with the man. It's perfect, Daryl. You have it down pat.
What happened after that? I don't recall how that...
He turned around and walked away because I didn't sit down and kept saying, here's my media registration form.
So you had a battle of wills and you beat Tebow, Bob Tebow. That's pretty good. That's a good story.
I was ready to go to jail.
Did he get all red in the face? I love it when
he does
that.
He's always red in the face.
he's usually flustered by something or other that we're doing there. So anyway, regarding what happened at the Shire Dude trial or hearing, we went into the building and, well, first of all, there was chalking going on outside, and then there was some interviews of Shire Dude happening outside, and the bailiffs came out almost immediately as I started to chalk. I was one of the first people to arrive, Derek and I grabbed some chalk and started chalking, and within moments, the bailiffs, two of them, were outside just sort of observing, and they stayed out there the entire time until we entered into the courthouse. Upon passing through the security checkpoint, one of the bailiffs, who I don't know if I've ever had much, if any, interaction with in the past, he came up and basically wanted to lecture everybody. He essentially kind of encouraged everyone to gather round as he gave us the, what for, and kind of...
Gather round, my children, and you shall hear the midnight tell of not Paul Revere, you're going to jail if you don't do what I say.
Nice Uncle Bailiff. I'm going to tell you the rules around here, give you the ins and outs, so I don't have to do anything.
Yeah, he was trying to ascertain who all had video cameras, and of course I told him, look,
who's
pretty
in
much,
charge here?
Pretty much everyone has a video camera, and he started just laying out these rules about, well, you got to ask permission and this and that, and at some point I just said, I'm out of here, and I just turned around and walked away. I don't need to be lectured to. I know what the rules of court are. I've got a lot of experience recording this, and I just walked off.
I stood there for approximately 30 seconds. I was like, nope, I can't do it. And I walked upstairs.
Right. I'm not obligated to stand there and listen to this guy. He wants me to stand there, and he wants to be in charge. He wants to have everyone paying rapt attention to him because he's so important.
My time's worth more than that.
That's how I felt about it. So I took off, and Renee came, and you came up.
We were upstairs just having conversation, waiting, and another bailiff came over and was like, so are you the spokesperson today? And you're like, I can talk for myself, but everybody's an individual. And he looks at me, and I go, I'm only in charge of myself, man.
Yeah, this is what they do. They want to find whoever they believe is in charge and get them to claim that they are in charge so they have someone that they can deal with, somebody who can be their man that they can go to and have that person essentially enforce the rules upon their friends. That's basically what they're trying to do there.
They want you to do the cat herding for them because they are ill-equipped.
And I'm not going to do it. And I'm not in charge, number one.
And Jim Johnson used to say that the 5-year-old was in charge, but that 5-year-old's now like 15.
He's not that old, I don't think.
Okay, maybe he's
like
13.
12 or something.
12,
yeah, getting
12
getting
13, close. 15, close enough.
Yeah, he no longer is.
He's no longer 5. He's no longer in charge.
Yeah, it's not as funny anymore. The joke was that he was the president, actually. So they would ask, whenever the bureaucrats would ask, who's in charge here, the activists would point to this guy, and he was just a kid, and that was pretty funny. So let's see. So this other guy comes up. He's like, well, are you the spokesperson today? And I said, well, I can speak with you, but I'm not going to speak on behalf of anyone else except for myself. And this guy actually and I have some rapport. So he's been around for a while in that particular courthouse. And he and I know each other from the Cheshire Fair, because a lot of these court security guys will go out and they'll work at the fairgrounds here in Cheshire County during the yearly Cheshire Fair, and I set up a booth out there every year, and Daryl, you help out a lot with that booth.
Yes.
And so you see the court security guys sort of in a different role. They're in a much more customer service-oriented role when they're doing security at Cheshire Fair, so they're a lot friendlier, and so he and I sort of have some rapport. We'll come back more on what happened at the supposed trial of Shire Dude this week It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Free Talk Live.
3-year-old child lost his arm after being viciously attacked by a pit bull terrier earlier this month.
Gosh.
Now the incident has moved a state lawmaker to author legislation that will effectively ban the pit bull breed in the entire state of Oklahoma.
Wow. Wouldn't all of Mr. Wesselhoff's constituents be a little safer if we all just couldn't have any dogs at all?
That's true. It would guarantee that no one would be bitten by dogs.
Right, and then and no cats.
What about cats? They scratch people.
They do scratch people, and it leaves a nasty infection.
It could, certainly.
Certainly.
We should ban infections, too, while we're at it. I mean, while we're protecting everyone from everything.
Birds can carry the flu. We know that.
You know, so. We should just exterminate all animals with teeth.
Well, forget the teeth. The birds have no teeth. I say we kill them all.
Just every animal.
Yeah.
Okay. What about insects? You could just sign a law that bans mosquitoes.
That'd be great.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, and you can join us toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got Ian,
Cecilyn,
and Daryl.
And ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Litecoin, or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. and they are a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check. Just start off at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you at ExpressCoin.com, and you can do it from your smartphone as well. They've got an app. Just go get it from ExpressCoin.com or just use their website. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll save on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency. You will pay no transfer fee on up to $40 worth over at ExpressCoin.com when you use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. As we continue here with what happened with Shire Dude's, what was supposed to be a triple parking ticket trial, he received basically $75 worth of tickets.
He won a continuance.
He won. Oh, I'm sure he felt like such a winner after this particular court date. The whole courtroom was pissed off today, this particular date. Not just the Free Staters, the liberty activists who were there, but nobody in court was happy with court.
It was a beautiful sight. Everybody on this side of the wooden railings were just like hopping irritated that the judge decided he didn't need to show up for 2 hours. And then everybody on that side, though, they're paid to be there, so they didn't care.
Were you the one who said the judge double booked? Or like,
yes. Well, yeah. What happened is the clerk said a comment about he was at a different hearing or something.
Right.
And I was like, well, maybe if you didn't prosecute all these victimless crimes that clog up the court system, you wouldn't overbook your judges and then you wouldn't be wasting people's time. She didn't really like me
nope.
Or the things that I had to say, because I was just pointing out all of the hypocrisy and the double standards and, you know, the pointlessness of it all.
And she couldn't do anything about it.
She couldn't do anything. She just kept looking at me and frowning and looking at her screen.
So we had to wait for quite a while. And in this nearly 2 hour time frame where we're all just in court, just sitting there waiting, there were multiple interactions with the bailiffs who were wanting us to not record anything until the judge came in. And I had an interaction with one of them where I made it very clear that, hey, look, dude, if you just stop talking to us, I won't record you. Maybe you shouldn't be arresting people. Now, he didn't arrest anybody, but I said something like, if you don't arrest people, you won't have a problem.
The exact quote is, just don't arrest anybody and you'll be fine.
Yeah. And if you just leave us alone, stop talking, I'll have no reason to hit the record button. So just leave us alone, basically, was sort of, I'm paraphrasing a much longer conversation. And then apparently when I left the room to take care of some business on the phone, there was even more ridiculous.
It was a magical conversation that we had. The bailiff came in to talk to Rob and to Derek about recording, you know, getting their names, and so he could tell the judge when he got there, so the judge could make a decision whether or not they could have all three of you recording, or whether it's just going to be the one person recording.
Now, that is a court rule. To be fair, that is one of the rules of the court where the judge can, if he feels so inclined, say, okay, multiple media is here. We only have so much room. You, media, you will be the main person recording, and then you have to share your recordings with the other media who is there. Now, luckily, he didn't require that. And I actually haven't seen them do that in quite a long time.
The last time I think that happened was when I had a hearing in Newport about 2.5 years ago, where there were, I don't know, a car full of activists that went up. Two people had cameras, and the judge said, only one of you can have a camera, and only one of them's on a tripod, so that guy gets to have it. And luckily, that was you.
In this case, the judge never even broached the subject of the multiple cameras when he came in.
Yeah, he just asked if it was okay with the defendant and with the prosecutor and went about the business. He was like, whatever.
Which, by the way, even if it's not okay with the defendant and prosecutor, I still have a right to come in there and record any public hearing in that courtroom, as far as I'm concerned. So really, this whole charade of, oh, well, we need to make sure this is okay. Do you have any objections? This whole thing is really just nothing more than for show. It's just to make them feel like they have some sort of power over the ability to record in court.
Well, if they tell you to turn off your camera and you do not do it, they will arrest you.
No, he said he didn't know what he was going to do. I asked him.
Yes, he kept refusing to say what he was like. Well, I don't know what I would do
this
in that
is the bailiff,
instance.
Just to be
yeah,
clear,
the bailiff. He's like, well, I don't know what I would do in that instance. I really don't think we have to get there. You know, if you just don't record people, and he kept going, well, don't talk to me, and I won't record you. Anything that's, you know, you talking to me, you're a public official, I think I should have a right to record you. And I love that you got him to admit. to agree with you that you should be able to record anything you want to, whether it's inside or outside
the courtroom. As he's walking out of the courtroom.
Again, my statement was, if the judge tells you to turn off your camera and you don't do it, he will have you arrested.
If the judge does, yes, that's true.
But well, in that's this contempt case, of court, because they can do whatever they want at that point.
That's true. Most of the interactions about the cameras happened without the judge in the courtroom. And so the ones we're describing here were the bailiffs trying to stop recording from happening.
Right, no, my statement was in response to yours of, I don't care what the judge says, I have a right to record.
Yeah, I do believe that I have the right to record. I don't think a judge would say...
Right, and he will have you arrested if you don't do what he says.
I understand that. That's contempt of court. I don't think a judge would say that you can't record a public hearing. I don't think he would do it. I think that it's just a charade where they make it look like, okay, you can record. I say I am the judge. I have the robe. And which he actually referenced
his robe. Well, what they said in Newport was... If one person did not turn off his camera, then he would not proceed with my trial until all of the cameras were removed from the courtroom. So, you know, there's very strong wording of, if you don't do what I say, there will be consequences. And consequences could end up with somebody going to jail.
No, I get what you're saying. I'm sorry if I'm miscommunicating. What I'm trying to make clear here is I don't believe a judge would say... You cannot record this trial. Not with 50 recorders or three. If there's one person there who wants to record a hearing, and the prosecutor and the defense the prosecution and defense object to it, I don't think it really matters whether they object to it. I think the judge would have to allow somebody to record a public trial.
I don't think he has to allow anything because the rules are written in leeway to where it's judge's discretion.
Again, the rules are made up.
That's true.
And your rights don't matter. But anyway, so back to when the bailiff came into the room before, you know, we got to Newport with you, honey. We'll come back to it. so the bailiff comes in and he's talking to them, and I start asking him questions because at this point, it's just an outreach event to me. I'm trying to reach the people on the other side of the peanut gallery.
Who I'd already flyered, by the way, with a don't take a plea deal flyer.
Which was awesome because they don't allow you to do that in Keene at
That's
all.
That's right.
So I'm starting to ask him, I'm like, so when's the judge supposed to show up? Does he get in trouble for not coming to work? You know, because when I don't show up for work, I get in trouble. And, you know, I know if Shire Dude hadn't showed up, he probably would have gotten arrested. Well, I don't think they would have arrested him. He surmised that they may have suspended his license. I was like, well, can we vote to take away the judge's license? And literally, I would say 75% of the peanut gallery, as I like to call them, raised their hands, including the normals over there. They're like, yeah, take away. And the one guy, I love this, the small business owner that stood up and he was talking to the clerk. He goes, is the judge going to get here at any time? Mm. I own my own business and I'm losing money right now. This is ridiculous.
Off. That guy was upset with the judge and he loved the flyer, by the way. He gave me a thumbs up from the other side of the room. And then there's another guy in the corner we talked to and sort of he shared his story and he loved the don't take a plea deal flyer. So just overall, it was such a successful event. I mean, even though it was boring for 2 hours, a lot of it was pretty dull, but there were so many great interactions that I think ultimately all of them probably did get captured on video, much to the chagrin of these bailiffs. And so that's going to make for a very interesting video, especially when Shire Dude gets a hold of it, because he has, you know, wonderful editing abilities, and I am looking forward to it.
He's so good. He got all of the Alt Expo videos for Porkfest from last year done in like a month. They've had them for like 10 months, and they've just been sitting there, and he cut them all up within a month, and now they're all out.
So to counter the bailiff's claim of, oh, they wouldn't arrest him if he didn't show up to court, we know otherwise from experience, where we know somebody that missed a court date one day because he wrote down the wrong day on his calendar. Mm-hmm. 2 hours after he didn't show up to court, he got arrested downtown Keene bench warrant.
Yep, that's not uncommon at all, actually. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. You can join us here. We'll talk a little more about what transpired at the Shire Dude hearing earlier this week in Manchester. And you can share your story about whatever's on your mind. Coming up, Uber crackdown in New York City. Hundreds of cars have been seized. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Free Talk Live.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. A liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, zog.ninja, code FTL.
The results are in. For the treatment of nasal allergy symptoms, nothing is more effective than Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of the worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. And in a recent clinical study with Nasacort going nose-to-nose with Flonase, more people prefer Nasacort. For more information, visit Nasacort.com. Nasacort. Use as directed.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $250,000 to do it. Your funds can be available in 5 days. There are no application fees, no annual fees, just quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. That's 800-430-4505.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Back with more Free Talk Live. We got time for you if you want to join us here. 855-450-FREE. Coming up, Uber crackdown in New York City with hundreds of Uber cars being seized. We'll tell you about that coming up here. Also, you can join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And joining you in studio, it's me, Ian.
And Cecilyn.
And Daryl.
Don't forget to join us over at freetalklive.com. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, then please, you can drop on by our website and become a Free Talk Live amplifier over at amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And the idea is to get Free Talk Live into more places around the world, get more listeners tuned in to the ideas of freedom. And if that's valuable to you, please support the show for $5 a month and get some great perks like access to the Amp Only Facebook group and Amp Only Forum, Amp Only Podcast. Go get all the details and get signed up for $5 a month with any major credit card through PayPal or use Visa or MasterCard right there on the site. So drop by amp.freetalklive.com and thank you in advance. Makes a big difference when you do that. That's again, amp.freetalklive.com. amp.freetalklive.com. Jesse is in Lake Isabella listening to KVLI. Hello, Jesse.
Hi, how you doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Yeah, I got a question. You know, if I had to do that and deal with the court systems like you guys do, I would look into seeing about a class action lawsuit against people and judges that think they're above the law. How many people were in that courthouse, would you guess? 50, 100 people or more?
Probably 30 or so.
In that courtroom, yeah, about 30 people.
Yeah, I'm listening to that call, and I'm thinking, if that was me right now, I would be getting names, and I would put these people up for lawsuits, class action lawsuits for your time.
Yeah, like, unfortunately, I don't think it would go anywhere.
We actually, Shire Dude and I were sitting there calculating about 2 hours for, I think we counted about 24 people at the time. It was roughly about $280 we could have been making at minimum wage, and that that's, of course, before theft. So post-theft was actually about $180 that you could take
and
home.
And that presumes minimum wage. Many people make much more than minimum wage.
Yeah, that's horrible. I mean, look into it. I hope you do. I really do. I'd like to hear something. I mean,
I don't want to shoot down your idea here, but I don't think it would really pan out, because this is standard behavior for courts to delay and make people wait and then dick them around even further and come up with arbitrary rules that don't make any sense. I mean, this is just the way things are in courts. We have actually a better situation in New Hampshire, because we can actually get a video camera into the courtroom. They'll arrest you if you record outside of the courtroom in some cases. And so it's not perfect here, but it's a little bit better than other places where you can't even get a camera in to the courtroom to observe what goes on in there. And I mean, just over the history of all the ridiculous trials and things that we've gone through up here, I've been the victim of a lot of arbitrariness by these government bureaucrats. Tons of delays, hours of my life have been, you know, shot away in these courthouses. And unfortunately, I don't think you'd have any standing to sue them for this. This is just how they do their business. I don't know, Daryl, what do you think? Is there a chance on that one?
I doubt it.
I mean, obviously, you should talk to an attorney.
Every
about
court I've ever been to in 5 different states, I've had delays. I have never had a trial start at the time that it was supposed to.
Oh, gosh. Well, kudos go out to you, you know, because you got good patience. And, you know, my wife was sitting here talking. I don't think we'd ever step on a courthouse ever again with what happened with us a couple of months back.
But, what happened?
You know, like we were talking about how we had to go down to the Kern County Courthouse, and we were trying to check out some paperwork on a levy. And my wife was already, she has RA, so she has problems with stress and all that. And
rheumatoid arthritis? Is that what RA stands for?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we go into the courthouse, we're looking up for the paperwork to try to attack this levy that the sheriff's department put on the house. Well, we get in there, and we're not getting too loud. We're in the halls. We're by the exit. We're not in the courtroom. And my wife's frustrated, and I'm frustrated. The paperwork's intimidating her. And I would call it on a scale from 1 to 10, probably a 3. I just blurted out, well, if we're going to get anything done, we're going to have to do it here. We're going to have to do it here. Next thing you know, 7 bailiffs are all over us. They're harassing us. They're taking her away. She's already having problems breathing. I mean, I don't know if they have evaporative coolers over air conditioning here in Bakersfield, but that courthouse was hot. She has enough stress problems. They're telling her to come over to the corner like we're fighting or something. So they're trying to break us apart like a fight broke out.
They claim you were making too much noise, and they wanted you to quiet down?
Oh, it wouldn't have been too much noise. We had this guy come over in a 3-piece suit first. He comes over, he stands in front of me, eye to eye. He flips out a badge, and he says, "Do you know who I am?" And he flips it up and flips it shut. And I said, "I don't know who you are. You didn't even give me 2 seconds to look at your badge number." Next thing you know, he's got 3 deputies, 3 more, and then the total was about 7 or 8. And they're all around us. And then I told you that one bailiff, had my wife over there, and he kept coming to my face telling me he was going to arrest me if I didn't leave the courthouse, and they were surrounding me.
For what? Were they claiming you were being too disruptive? Why did you have to leave, according to them?
He didn't even say we were disrupted. He just, I guess, apparently they just pulled her away, thought a spousal dispute broke out, and then got her in a corner, and she's even in more stress and crying and tearing up because now everything's 10 times as bad. She tells the deputies, "Now you just made everything even worse." And he thinks that he looks at her and says, "Worse? What do you mean?" And she says, "You just made it worse. We get in here, we're trying to take care of something, and you ramp up the agitation." And, they're all over the place. And we got this one deputy in the background I told you about that just keeps agitating it. He keeps bouncing around. He keeps telling my wife, "Look, I can get you out of here." Now, is this creepy or what? Think about it. he keeps telling her, do you want me to take you home? She says, no, I don't have a problem here. And she's explaining to them what happened. Well, this goes on for about 20 minutes. I go outside finally because this jerk's in my face. He stops bouncing. He says, get out of here. The same bailiff that starts agitating the thing. Mm-hmm. The other guy's broken off. She's surrounded by five or six herself. She can't even breathe. As
That's scary.
They're practically. Yeah, so I go outside and had to call, I guess, a watch commander at that time and told him what was going on. And he broke it up, I guess, because she comes out about 10 minutes later. And I'm at the picnic table, and my goodness, man. But just the fact of going in there for something like that, and if we ever see a jury summons again, I don't know how we're going to react.
It's
to that,
a very
know?
Intimidating process. They don't want you to want to be in court, right? Like, so they do everything they can to be as intimidating and as awful and as, you know, uncustomer service oriented as they possibly can, because they want it to be an awful, harrowing experience to be in court, because they want you to take a plea deal. They want you to just do what they tell you to do and, you know, get it done rather than actually challenge something. Thanks, Jesse, for sharing your story tonight. I appreciate it.
They really do that. And in Shire Dude's case, they actually made him post the $75 in tickets beforehand. So it's even more of a disincentive to go to trial because you've already paid the money, and at that point you're just wasting your time.
I heard
there
about
are
that,
some
yeah.
states where they require you to do that.
Yeah,
that's what they do in Manchester.
In Manchester, they require you to post your whatever your fines are for you to go to trial. And the judge, you know, once he finally showed up, he did say if he makes a judgment, it might be less or it could be something else. He did actually imply that it could be more than that $75. That
really?
He did imply that he
what?
Said it could. I could rule and it could be less, it could be the same, or there could be more of a sentence.
So this is something I don't understand, and I'd heard this about Manchester previously, that you have to pay the fine in advance prior to them scheduling a trial. And I don't know if it only applies to parking tickets or if it applies to everything that you get in Manchester, because I've only ever heard of it in regards to parking tickets, but I think the only time anyone's ever challenged anything out that way thus far has pretty much been parking tickets, at least in recent times.
It's the first time I've heard of it, but I would probably agree with you. It's the first thing other than like the chalking instances where, you know, there was actual bail.
But it makes me wonder, how does that happen? I mean, in Keene, that doesn't happen at all, right? Like, you go, you challenge the thing, and they schedule a court date for you, and then they find you guilty, and then, you know, they want you to pay it.
My guess is one of two things, and we really need to consult one of the Liberty lawyers mm-hmm. to find out which of these two it is. Either the ordinances and charter of the city of Manchester have been amended in such a way as to where that is required, or there is a city ordinance that has been passed against state law and no one has challenged the validity of the ordinance. Because
it wouldn't make sense for the courts to be operating in two different fashions about
right, because that. Like the synthetic cannabis ban in Keene.
Totally illegal.
Yeah. But even though, well, anyway. There's state legislation, so
they did it while saying that they realized this could be challenged and thrown out.
Right. And just nobody has yet challenged it. Every time I go to Concord, I forget to go to the Attorney General's office to say I want to challenge this. But
can
there's
you do
been
that? Can you just challenge some sort of city ordinance without actually getting arrested first?
I've heard that that's one of two ways that you can challenge it. They might throw it out and say you don't have standing because you've not been harmed. But yes, you can.
If it was your intention to sell spice, then you would have been harmed, right? By the virtue of the fact that you couldn't start your business spice selling business.
Right.
All right, on the way here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I got a few more comments on the guy in California and the intimidating, threatening, scary situation that he and his wife found themselves in court. 855-450-FREE if you want to tell your story. We got hour number three on the way. Plenty of time for you, plus the Uber crackdown in New York City. It's all coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Here's a good idea.
When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, June 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.19 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,202 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $249. Antiwar.com reports, the first 3 days of the Yemen peace talks in Geneva were pretty unproductive, but at least no one got hit. The situation took a turn for the worse on Thursday when the Houthis' attempt to hold a press event was attacked by supporters of the Hadi faction. Houthi delegate Hamza al-Houthi was delivering his address to the assembled media when one of the Hadi delegates rushed the stage and threw a shoe at him. Shoes started flying back and forth despite Houthis' attempt to keep talking and ignore the disruption, and before long, fistfights were reported between the two factions. The Hadi government resigned back in January after the Houthis had taken over the capital city of Sana'a. The Saudis attacked Yemen in March, demanding the Hadi forces be reinstalled. After 3 months of war, however, there is no sign of this happening, and the Houthis still control most of the country. The peace talks got off to a bad start when the Hadi faction demanded that the Houthis surrender every city in the country as a condition of direct talks. Very little has come of the peace talks, however, and the fight is probably going to be the most noteworthy thing that's happened. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. All of your funds on Coinbase are safe, with approximately 90% of customer funds being stored offline, and all wallets are stored using AES 256 encryption. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports the Federal Communications Commission on Thursday voted in favor of covering broadband internet access for low-income households with a telephone subsidy program it has offered for 30 years. Three of the five members of the FCC voted in favor of reforming the program called Lifeline to include web access. Established in 1985, the Lifeline program has provided qualifying low-income Americans with a $9.25 per month subsidy towards phone service. Thursday's vote favors expanding it to include broadband internet, though the final structure of what that may look like is yet to be determined. Expanding the program still needs further government approval, where there is opposition to the expansion proposal. Some critics believe the $2 billion per year Lifeline program is already rife with abuses and fraud, and that the existing program should be fixed before it should be expanded. One Republican commissioner said in a report by The Hill, "We still have a long way to go if we are going to fix this program. Waste, fraud, and abuse are still rampant." In a news release Thursday, however, the FCC indicated that abuses of Lifeline have largely been eliminated and that further reforms are being developed to make sure that the program is helping the poor it's designed to help.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports the U.S. Supreme Court on Thursday unanimously reinstated an Ohio man's conviction for beating his girlfriend's children after he sent her thousands of miles away to engage in prostitution. The nine justices rejected the arguments made by defendant Darius Clark that testimony given during trial by preschool teachers who talked to one of the victims, his girlfriend's three-year-old son, should have been disallowed. The testimony in question, in which the teacher pressed the boy on injuries they had noticed, did not violate Clark's rights under the U.S. Constitution's Sixth Amendment to confront his accusers, according to the court. Clark was convicted of abusing the three-year-old boy and the boy's 18-month-old sister. He was sentenced to 28 years in prison, but appeals court threw out the conviction, saying the teacher's testimony at trial was impermissible evidence. Teachers at the boy's preschool noticed what appeared to be injuries, and during trial, the teachers testified about the conversations they had with the boy. Justice Samuel Alito, writing on behalf of the court, wrote that the statements were admissible at trial because the teachers were not soliciting the information with the intent of using it as evidence. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Reflecting on the persistent troubles it caused his sibling during childhood, local doctor Daniel Barrett told reporters this week about his average-looking brother, Kevin, who first inspired him to be a cosmetic surgeon.
As a kid, I remembered thinking that there was nothing I could do for Kevin. Watching someone you really love and care about suffer from a weak jawline or unsymmetrical features, it had a major impact on me.
And in this week's local news, a community theater gives the part of Blanche DuBois to Kathy f***ing Hamilton. In other news, a moviegoer manages to sneak candy past a teenage usher earning $7 an hour. A new app matches you with others in the vicinity who wasted $2.99 on the same app. And a Roman centurion crawling out of a New York City manhole cover is in for one wacky adventure. Having graciously spread my knowledge to the uneducated masses, I now return to the stately, elegant ranks of News Announcer Society. For more, keep checking TheOnion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Back with Free Talk Live, launching into the third hour of the program. Coming up, hundreds of cars have been seized in New York City for being Uber cars. We'll talk about what's happening there. It's outrageous, and yet another in a long line of just horrible things that has been happening to the Uber company on behalf of various governments around the U.S. and around the world. So that's on deck here. Of course, you may call in about anything you'd like to discuss. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're going to go into your calls and thoughts here. By the way, tonight in studio, you've got me, Ian.
Cecilyn.
And Daryl.
Just to bring you up to speed in case you're just tuning in, we spent the bulk of the last hour talking about the Shire dude, what was to be a trial for parking tickets this week. It ended up being continued, but there was a lot of interactions that happened between the activists, there was like a dozen of them, and the bailiffs in the courthouse over recording video and a variety of other things regarding your rights. We then had another guy call in from California talking about his wife and he who had gone to this courthouse, and bailiffs there were very intimidating and they outnumbered them and it was kind of a scary thing. And I wanted to just kind of expound on that here in a here for a moment, and then we'll get to your calls and thoughts at 855-450-FREE or Skype us at username lrn.fm. So this is one of the benefits of being in New Hampshire, is you can outnumber them as the activists. You know, we had a dozen activists in that courtroom. There were then another probably 15 or so people on the other side of the court who were mostly friendly to us and who really liked the fact that we were there and that we were standing up for ourselves and talking back to these bailiffs.
And the one lady, as we were leaving, said, you know, oh, stick around, I may need you to record for me.
Oh, I didn't hear that. That's nice. So the it is an intimidating process, and having people there with you makes it a lot better. In fact, I believe Shire Dude made some sort of comment about that
afterwards about how it felt a lot better going into this situation, which is normally a very scary, very sort of nerve-wracking, intimidating thing where, you know, any wrong move and those men with guns can put you in handcuffs and put you in a cage. If the man in the robe doesn't like something you do, then he can order them to do that. And that's just always hovering above you. It's hanging like an axe above you, and you know that, you know, you are at their it's at their discretion whether they're going to hurt you or not when you're in there. But having people with you can really help shore up your level of courage and your willingness to stand up for yourself. And, you know, I feel bad when I hear from people in other places who aren't, you know, they don't have a community that is the size of the Liberty community here in New Hampshire to back them up. They're going alone into these courthouses, and that's scary.
Well, then they should just move to New Hampshire for the Free State Project, and they won't have those problems anymore.
Exactly. And in point of fact, there are people who are moving up here right now. In fact, the Porcupine Freedom Festival is coming up this weekend. It's going to kick off on Sunday. We should talk about that coming up here as well when we get the chance. But what a great excuse to come up to New Hampshire and check this place out, because maybe you've heard us talking about the Free State Project, the idea of libertarians converging to one geographic area. In this case, it's New Hampshire, and getting active so we can achieve more liberty in our lifetime. Perhaps you've heard about it. Perhaps you've heard us talking about some of the stories that happen up here, and you just aren't sure if it's for real. Come to the Porcupine Freedom Festival, and you will know that this is real. You will know what the community is capable of and what it's like and the wonderful people that are a part of it. There really is no better showcase for, I think, the Liberty community than the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
I would wholeheartedly agree. And if you come up, you'll never want to leave. It happens all the time.
And if you come up to Porkfest, Jay Noon might just cook you a hamburger. At least that's what he was doing there last
year. He's not going to be there this year.
Oh, no. Jay, you're not going to make it to Porkfest?
No, I can't make it. I'm out here in Colorado working, and I tried to buy some plane tickets the other day because I wasn't sure what day I could leave. So, yeah, I paid for my campsite, I bought tickets, and I was in a little bit of a state of depression for about a day when I finally realized I can't go.
Oh, that's so heartbreaking.
I don't know what Porkfest is going to be like without Jay Noon.
It'll be fun.
It will be fun.
You'll
be
missed.
Fun no matter what for whoever goes there.
Well, is your brother going?
Yeah. Okay. Actually, all my brothers are going.
Oh, great. Well, we'll have plenty of noons.
Hold on. You've got more than one brother?
I have three brothers that are noons, and I have a brother and sister out here in Colorado also.
Daryl, do you know about this thing called the internet and Facebook and family connections?
Yeah, I only knew his brother Josh, and I actually married Josh and his
wife. You married Josh?
A couple of years ago.
That's right, yep.
Was a stateless wedding.
So, Jay, you were actually not calling to talk about the Porcupine Freedom Festival, but you've been there and have been a fixture at it for many years, and I'm sure you'll be back next year if you get the chance to come out.
I'm not missing it next year.
What I love that Jay did last year was he saw a need in the marketplace and he filled it. He actually pulled his truck up to they have this big campfire that goes on pretty much every single night. It's just like going throughout the week, and it gets big during the night times. And you know, almost nobody was open at 2 a.m. selling food. There's a lot of food being sold at the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
Well, to be fair, the Porcupine Freedom Festival goes from 8 a.m. until 11:59 p.m. And then what people choose to do after that is totally on them.
Well, there were some vendors that were selling late.
That's totally up to them. But the actual festival ends at 11:59.
I see.
I had trouble last year finding breakfast that was fast and good.
Don't worry, guys. I got it covered this year. There's lots of food vendors. I think everyone's going to be happy. It's going to be the best pork fest ever. Good. There's not going to be any issues. And it's going to be all smiles and rainbows.
But so nice if thing. I wake up at 7 o'clock and don't find breakfast, I know where to go complain.
You can come to try to find me, but I'll be hiding.
Or hotel room or wherever it is she's going to be hiding.
None of you know where I live.
So, Jay, you did a great job last year providing late night eats for people toward the weekend of the Porcupine Freedom Festival. And I for one, appreciated it because it was convenient and it was good. So you will be missed for sure. But you were calling about this courtroom stuff specifically. What?
Well, in Massachusetts, when you get a civil infraction, like a speeding ticket or something, back when I used to get civil infractions, now I purposely make them all criminal infractions when they start to happen. But what would happen is you could send it in for an appeal, the ticket, and you had to pay a $25 fee. Or you probably still have to. I haven't done it in a long time. what I did is Section 40, if anybody wants to look this up, of the Magna Carta. Now, the Magna Carta, allegedly, according to the Constitution, applies to all government agents, such as magistrates, when you have a magistrate's hearing. And it says, we, as in those who the Magna Carta applies to, as those who the Constitution applies to, those who have an oath to the Constitution, Section 40 of Magna Carta says, we will not charge nor deny justice. So they wanted $25. So I would write up a little thing when I send in my ticket stating, if you're going to charge $25 for this appeal, then you will be in violation of an international treaty as per, you know, the Magna Carta as prescribed by whatever article of the U.S. Constitution and says that they can't charge for justice. I mean, there's a, you know, other treaties, existing treaties apply. And I probably did that, eight or nine times. And literally every single time that I did that, I went into the hearing, and they never said anything about the fee. And people, like, sometimes these hearings, like in Greenfield, these hearings are in a big open courtroom, and they're like, people would say, how come they didn't make you pay the $25? And I'd say, well, because they can't. The Magna Carta says they can't deny it or charge it for justice.
So just to be clear, you would most people pay the $25. You instead would send a note referencing international law, the Magna Carta, and then you would not send the $25. Would you normally have to send that in advance or pay it the day of the trial? How does it? When do they normally expect it to be paid?
Not yet. Actually, if you didn't send it in advance and you didn't pay them the $25 cash right there, because at the one in Greenfield where you get to see everybody's hearing, you have to take it by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't send in $25, so you must pay this $25 fee right now. And there are some people who just didn't have the $25, and they're like, well, you know, you're
so they would schedule the hearing. Just to be clear, if you didn't pay the $25 in advance, they would still schedule the hearing and then demand the $25 before the hearing?
Yep.
But with you, they mysteriously didn't demand it. Jay, I'm looking forward to seeing you up here in New Hampshire one of these days where we can document some of this stuff that you do in court. I find it always fascinating, and I appreciate your call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Yeah, come on up to New Hampshire and try all your court theories out. Some of them probably aren't going to work, but if it does, we can get it on video. I think that'd be pretty cool. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. We've got Skype as well. Skype username's lrn.fm.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners. So you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live and plenty of time for you to join us here at 855-450-FREE. What do you want to talk about? Court shenanigans, or whatever's on your mind. It goes here if you dial in and join us at 855-450-FREE. Joining you tonight in studio, you've got Ian here.
And Cecilyn.
And Daryl.
And don't forget, we also have Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, so you can reach out to us in that way. Cecilyn, should a listener of Free Talk Live want to know more about what you're up to, where would they go for that?
You can find me on Facebook.
Under the name Cecilyn.
C-E-C.
You have a page.
Yeah, I have a page.
Right.
You linked it last time.
Correct.
And I got like 10 new likes from it. It was amazing.
Not bad. So yeah, check her out. And she's doing a lot with the Porcupine Freedom Festival. You're organizing all the vendor areas, basically. Right?
Correct. But real quick, I wanted to finish up with Shire Dude,
because
we never actually got to the end of the story.
We talked about all the stuff that went on before the judge came in with the harassment by the bailiffs, etc.
I mean, the judge was literally only there for like 5-10 minutes, while we were there at least, because they called him first.
They called him first.
By that time, they're like, just get them out of here. Just come on.
Did they call him Mr. Dude, or did they call him Shire?
They called him by his real name, and they totally butchered his last name. Just like,
it's a tough one to get right. I mean, just on when you look at his last name, can we say it on the air? I mean, he goes by it on.
No, he doesn't.
No, he goes by it on.
His name's Shire Dude.
Okay, well, then I guess I can't explain how you would.
It's one of these weird, like Italian looking words.
It has a bunch of extra letters that aren't pronounced.
Oh, it's not silent. You just don't pronounce a hard G.
Okay, it's pretty much silent though.
It's Italian, but anywho. So once the judge finally got there, you know, Shire Dude goes up and sits at the little table.
Tortellini.
And the reason I called it the day
that
nobody.
It's silent.
Daryl, you're doing the thing. So, he goes up there, and the whole reason I called the day
with his hat on, and you wore your hat, and nobody
on our side stood. Half of those people on the other side didn't stand either, which I thought was pretty cool.
Yes.
So he goes up there, and the whole reason I call it the day that nobody showed up for work is because the prosecutor didn't even show up for work. The prosecutor that was assigned to his case was sick that day or
that
under
the
weather.
Claim.
So they didn't show up to court. Another prosecutor in their stead stood there and filed a motion for continuance.
To which Shardud objected.
He did.
However, he never made an argument as to why he objected. He just simply registered his objection. Not that if he'd said more that it would have helped him, but it couldn't hurt.
His whole thing, he just wanted to go there and to get them to let him donate the money to charity instead of it going to whatever ambiguous government type thing it would have gone to. Mm-hmm. And he just wanted to have that conversation with the judge. And the judge was like, hold on, let's talk about this continuance first. Are you okay with it? No, I'm not okay with it, but can I just ask you a couple questions? Well, I'm going to go ahead and allow the continuance because, you know, I want to be fair, not just to you, but to the state. I want to give everyone a chance to present their side. And, you know, if you were sick, I would extend that courtesy to you.
And they would. And that's a true statement.
I don't believe that for 1 second.
Not unless you petition them 10 days in advance and let them know that you were unable to come to trial. They would issue a bench warrant and come arrest you.
I don't know about that.
They've arrested people for missing a trial 2 hours
but
after they missed
give
the
notice?
Trial.
Did that person give notice? Did the people who were arrested say, hey, call the court, I'm sick, I can't make it in there today? Did they try that? No, just didn't show up.
Well,
that's what I'm talking about here. If Shire Dude were to have said he was sick in advance, you know, called the court from his hospital bed or, you know, wherever, at home where he's in bed, and then tell them that he
still
can't make it because of that. I believe the judge with that claim. But the thing that was really bothersome about the judge's appearance, besides the fact that that he was 2 hours late before he came in.
Didn't even apologize.
That's true.
Being a government employee means never having to say you're sorry.
He had an attitude of like good old buddy buddy, and like he was making kind of jokes about how, well, I've got the robe on, so I'm in charge, and was just kind of had this demeanor like it was no big deal that he was 2 hours late.
Hold on, that reminds me of one of these college prank video things that I saw where some guy shows up 5 minutes before the class is supposed to start.
And takes over as a teacher?
Takes over as the teacher.
That was pretty good.
And he starts convincing some of the kids to, like, drop the class. Like, half of you are going to fail and this and that. And 90% of the students last year failed this class. And, like, kids are putting laptops away and getting up to walk out. And then some guy walks in and says, who the hell are you? And it was the teacher walking in. So this kid just, like, then ran. So, but, like, just somebody being like, I'm wearing the robe, so I'm in charge, just sounds like one of these prank videos where, like, hey, next door neighbor, you want to go be the judge today? I don't feel like going in. Just show up late.
Well, we joked that during the hearing, we had joked that it should be where if the judge is late, that anyone in the audience can just go and sit behind and take over for the judge role. But one of the things that was total BS about this was the prosecutor claiming, the actual prosecutor who's got this case is sick and we can't move forward with this. Anybody who's ever seen a parking ticket case knows how open and shut these cases are. There's no real need to prepare in advance for this. That prosecutor absolutely could have taken that ticket to trial. Just call the bureaucrats were there. The parking enforcers were there. They were ready to go to trial. You just call the witness up, ask him some basic questions about where the ticket was written, and then case closed. You're guilty.
And Sherry pointed that out. He's like, it's parking tickets. It's not like it's right. That hard.
It's super easy. So it was total, in my opinion, it was total BS
really
that they couldn't
easy.
Move forward with that case on
it's
in that
always
moment.
BS. They and were, I had a thing in Keene one time where the prosecutor, the Amazon, filed the wrong charge on the paper, and I challenged that. Judge Burke said, well, clearly it's a mistake.
They'll just amend it right there. Yeah.
Now, you need to watch yourself. One of these days, you'll make this mistake on a hearing that actually matters.
Yeah, one of these days, I might actually do something to you rather than wag my finger at you and talk at you. I mean, this woman has messed up more than once, not just in that case, but she has screwed
up. Yeah,
I had
a parking ticket, and she put me down for disobeying an officer.
Well, to be fair, guys, prosecutors and public defenders are lawyers who didn't get good grades. They couldn't hack it in the private sector, so they work for the state because the state will hire anybody.
Well, I mean, that's a general statement. I think that there are some public defenders who are actually pretty decent, But there aren't that many.
Well, clearly this woman is a prosecutor continually making mistakes. She did not make the grade. Therefore, she works for the state.
So yeah. I think this was an excuse. They wanted to put Shire Dude off to another date just to screw him around, basically, because they know they're getting paid to be there. And Shire Dude and the rest of the audience is not being paid to be there. And so now he's going to have to take another day off of work, just like the businessman. Almost everybody was continued in that courtroom that day. And people were really upset about that. And that's what they want to do. They want to string you along. They want to screw you around. And they want to frustrate you to the point where you'll say next time, this just isn't worth the hassle. I'll pay the ticket.
And my guess is, because I know I've had this happen to me, Ian, I think you've had it happen to you. And I know others have had it happen to them on parking tickets, to where the judge takes them off into this little side room. Mm-hmm. And tries to have their trial in the little side room to yep. where nobody sees it. The last time Judge Burke tried that on me, I demanded my right to a public trial. And well, he made me sit there for 2 hours until everybody else was called. Gone. Yeah. And then I was called.
All right. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. I don't know if there's more from the Shire Dude thing.
Anything that's all about it.
All right, let's talk about Porkfest. It is imminent. We are literally less than 2 days away from the kickoff of the Porcupine Freedom Festival, and Cecilyn is involved in that. Plus, the Uber thing, if we get the chance, it's all coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people, like when the jeweler ruined my ring and wouldn't do anything about it. But when my Legal Shield attorney called him and told him what my rights were, I received a check for over $2,100. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. Again, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenevention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenevention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenevention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and you're welcome to join us here on the phones at 855-450-FREE or via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Tonight in studio, Ian here.
Cecilyn.
And Daryl.
This week, Peacekeeper has launched an Indiegogo campaign for Peacekeeper 2.0. Now, if you recall, Peacekeeper 1.0 came out last year. There were some problems, limited features, persistent bugs, and a lack of a real network. They've, for the last 6 months, been learning from their mistakes on the first app, and they know what does work and what doesn't work and how to build on it. But they're looking to raise some money to fund Peacekeeper 2.0. It has the potential to be world-changing. They're creating new features like a verified network of peacekeepers you can call in an emergency. And no longer will you just have to rely on your groups and alliances. Now, every peacekeeper in the area is a potential ally. They're hiring a new developer to create this powerful bug-free system, and they're renovating marketing and hoping they can bring in 100,000 users in the next year and show the state what real change looks like. They need your help for this. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement, a revolutionary system designed to challenge the status quo. It's a tool that will allow ordinary people to stand up and be heroes. It's a fast, flexible alert system that can help keep you safe better than dialing 911. Peacekeeper can change the world, and you can help by contributing to their Indiegogo campaign today and get some perks over at pk.freetalklive.com. That's a link. It'll forward you to the Indiegogo page. PK, like Peacekeeper, pk.freetalklive.com. If you want to see Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means, contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today at pk.freetalklive.com. Jesse is in St. Louis. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Cecilyn, and Daryl. Hello, Jesse. Jesse, going once.
Kathy. I don't know what Jesse. I don't know if you're talking to me or someone
That is
else.
You, Kathy. Welcome. You are on the air. Sorry about that.
Oh, that's okay. I was like, huh, are you talking to me? Are they on live? What?
Go for
it. No, I was calling in. I wasn't sure what the topic was tonight. Somebody had put your all the website for the radio station up on Facebook, and I said, well, I'm going to call in and see what the topic is. And when I started explaining who I was, they said, well, hold on a second. I said, okay. But basically, I was one of America's top mortgage collectors until my company, come to find out, lied about the right to sell mortgage notes. And they lied about the right to sell mortgage notes for Chase.
They lied about it?
Yes.
So these mortgage notes, are these the mortgage-backed security things that got a lot of companies in trouble back during the housing bubble?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
What I figured out, the company that lied, which is National Asset Recovery Services.
Allegedly. Okay.
Their board of directors are over 35 of America's top law offices, putting fraud into the courts, knowing it's fraud. That the fraud is so perverse, I found out that for almost 80 years, they have told Americans that my grandmother didn't exist. And even you will know her by her fictional name, which is Katie Scarlett O'Hara, as in Gone with the Wind.
Okay.
I know, right? Kind of a wild thing, but what happened was is once they lied about the right to sell mortgage notes, you know, I got put in a situation because for 2.5 years I was told that they had it within their contract to sell mortgage notes for Chase. Who am I going to get to show me a contract that shows their capability to sell mortgage notes for one of the largest banks in the world? You're not going to get that in America, okay? But they told me that they did have that right for 2.5 years. Come to find out, long story short, it was an assumed practice that the collection agency continued on with when Chase bought out Advanta. At any rate,
I don't understand all the ins and outs of like these things, mortgage-backed securities or whatever the heck all that is. How does this matter to my listeners?
Well, I mean, everybody's heard about the banking foreclosure crisis. They are creating fraud against us, knowing it's fraud. That the fraud is so perverse that they've said my grandmother did not exist for almost 80 years. You know, millions of Americans have heard of my grandmother by her fictional name. You know, I think it matters because, you know, the Civil War happened in this country, right? And we don't know what happened back in the Civil War. We can't even be told our true names. Because I went to court, and I went to court with a way to pay my bills.
Daryl, you look about as confused as I feel right now.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what the Civil War has to do with mortgage-backed securities. Like, I understand that people that run big mega banks lie to people, and they did some shady things, but are you alleging that, like, J.P. Morgan Chase started the Civil War to claim that your grandmother didn't exist? Like, this is, I don't understand all of the things that you're mentioning and how they connect.
It's all separate things. Today, you know, I'm actually a courier. I was, you know, a mortgage collector, okay? After 2.5 years, I found out they lied about having that right, okay? I tried to do the right thing and have a way to pay my bills. The only way I could get to pay my bills is if I had bankers doing honest business, because that's the business I was in, was doing banking and doing honest banking. Somebody tells me I have the right to sell mortgage notes for one of the largest banks in the world. I think if they tell me that, that should be the truth. Otherwise, that harms me and that harms anybody. That
and so you were told that you had the right to sell these mortgage notes, but you actually, in point of fact, didn't. And that how affected you in what way?
Well, I lost my job because once I sold $80,000 in mortgage notes, come to find out they never had it in their contract to sell them.
Yeah, that certainly seems like a real problem. So, I mean, was there some sort of dispute that you went to court for about that? Hello?
The court case that happened over the mortgage notes that were sold.
Gotcha. Thanks for the call tonight, Jesse. I really don't know where to go with it. I don't, mortgage security, whatever all this stuff is, it means nothing to me. I don't know what that stuff is, and it's hard for me to really relate to it.
I have no idea what that one was talking about.
Yeah.
So the mortgage-backed securities, I know a little bit about what they are, and my understanding might be a little off from what it actually is.
I'm so glad you're here,
Daryl. I know what a mortgage is.
But what the banks would do is they would bundle this debt from various mortgages.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just say that you, Cecilyn, and I all have a mortgage, not on the same three different mortgages.
Okay.
So the bank that we owe money to would bundle that together and then sell that as an investment to another bank. And then that other bank would then take like part of your debt and part of mine and part of Cecilyn's, put it in another mortgage-backed security, and then sell that to a third bank. So we actually owed our money to like five different places, but we were only ever told of one bank. So there were a lot of weird, tricky things that were happening with these mortgage-backed securities.
Mm.
So a lot of the foreclosures, people have challenged those as being fraudulent foreclosures because the mortgage was transferred without the homeowner ever knowing.
Yeah, I've heard about
the mortgage was transferred. So there were some weird things with the mortgage-backed securities. But I have absolutely no clue how any of that connected to the Civil War and whether or not Scarlett O'Hara as an actual person existed or not.
Yeah, I found it all very, very confusing. I did my best. I swear I did my best to try to understand that. Sorry. 855-450-FREE. We're just talk show hosts, not mortgage security experts. But if she was defrauded in some way, I feel bad for her. And
right.
If she was defrauded by a bank, I feel super bad for her because it's got to be hard to go up against the banks. I mean, they've got all kinds of resources.
It's near impossible, especially when they're getting government bailouts to cover their losses from all of these weird shady deals that they were doing in the first place. And there were a couple of banks that were recently found to have violated some government provision of something, and instead of giving the money to the people that they defrauded, they're having to pay penalties to the U.S. government that is in no way going to return that money to people that were defrauded.
There was a court ruling that I reported on earlier this week out of California, where a judge in California ruled that a specific bank, I forget which one, had to pay $331 million of restitution that would somehow go back to the homeowners, but they don't know how that's going to wind up happening because, you know, they don't know who it was.
All right, the toll-free number here tonight, 855-450-FREE. You can call in. Hopefully you're coherent when you call the show. Otherwise, we will do our best to figure out what you're talking about. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. One segment remains. There's enough time for you if you want to join us here about whatever's on your mind. Skype username is lrn.fm. Coming up, the Porcupine Freedom Festival is coming up starting Sunday. We'll talk more about what's happening.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting.
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Ha ha.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
OrcFest.com. It begins in a matter of just over a day. Sunday is the official kickoff. I don't know at what time. Do you know, Cecilyn, at what time people who are arriving on Sunday will be able to check in?
Registration opens at noon.
Okay. So, yeah. So we are just about 36, 39 hours away from the beginning of the Porcupine Freedom Festival. This is the 12th one, if I'm not mistaken.
Is correct.
Right? It is the 2015 Porcupine Freedom Festival, the yearly camping festival that happens in the northern portion of New Hampshire and Lancaster.
How many have you been to?
Since 2007.
This is number four.
I've been to more Pork Fest than you have.
Well, I didn't actually go to Pork Fest for the first time until after I had moved.
Me neither. Which I was fine with. I'm actually glad I didn't.
I came to two of them before I moved.
I think it would have been really overwhelming to. I mean, it must be super overwhelming for somebody who's never been to New Hampshire before to come and visit during the Porcupine Freedom Festival, because it's such an amazing event with so many people. Usually at least 1,500 people is sort of the minimum for the event these days. Maybe it'll hit 2,000 this year as far as attendees. I mean, this is the most Liberty people that most people have ever experienced at any one time in their entire life.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd actually gone to the one in 2011 if I had moved, because I would have spent all of the money that I had in savings in order to, you know, buy a last-minute plane ticket and fly up and everything.
Yeah, no good.
But I listened every single night to Free Talk Live, and I could just hear all of the partying going on in the background, and I was like, man, that's where I want to be. And then, you know, a month and a half later, I'm here.
You were there. And it is happening, and it's wonderful, and it's grown so much, and it's been really fun to be a part of it the whole time. And, of course, Free Talk Live is going to be broadcasting live throughout the week. And you will, of course, if you're there, you're welcome to join us in the studio. There are all kinds of other great shows we'll be broadcasting live as well, including Derek J. And you're going to be recording your show.
I'll be recording live
studio.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 1 o'clock.
But this isn't a media event. We're just sort of a sideshow. The real event is the festival, which there's so much going on all at once. I mean, Cecilyn, where do you even begin to talk about what's happening at Pork Fest? There's just so much.
Well, I mean, me being me, I'm going to talk about Agoura Valley because that's what I've been living for like the last 3 months.
You're the organizer of Agoura Valley. And what is Agoura Valley?
Agoura Valley is essentially the downtown marketplace of Pork Fest. There are a number of vendors, both some who are agorist and then some who are more professional, who sell things throughout the week, be it from food to items. There's lots of different goods and services.
Hold on.
Go ahead.
You made a statement that seems to imply that people who are agorist are not professional. You said some businesses are agorist and others are professional.
Professional as in they're a food truck.
Okay.
As in they go to festivals.
They do this outside of Pork Fest, whereas some people create a business just for Pork Fest, basically. They sell food, they make food for folks, and they would never make food at any other festival.
Right, but food isn't the only thing that happened. Like
in Agoura Valley,
you know,
that's
like
true.
Actual businesses.
T-shirts.
Like T-shirts.
Massage.
Books.
Soaps, essential oils, clothing, hand-knitted hats. There's informational booths. There's two different Bitcoin vendors. One's a startup business for like tipping and stuff, and the other one is like a new service provider. There's Agoura Valley is literally almost full. I have two sites that are still open, so if someone were to come in on Sunday and is like, I got the money.
First come, first serve.
There you go. You could have, I got two left. You could totally have them. But what I'm so excited about is that this year, since Porkfest took over placement and payment for Agoura Valley, everything in Agoura Valley is strictly a vendor. So there might be people sleeping there, but you're not going to run into what you've run into in the past of just someone randomly in the middle of Agoura Valley just camping there and not being a vendor and just kind of taking up that space.
I see.
Almost four full rows of vendors, which I think is great.
Now, are there going to be vendors outside of Agoura Valley at all? Because last year there was some of that.
There are a number of vendors who have chose to vend outside of Agoura Valley, which is totally fine. If you want to, you know, sell something on your site, or if you want to walk around, you know, with water bottles, whatever, that's cool. But there are so many advantages to being in Agoura Valley.
Sure, like, that's the destination for people that are hungry or want to buy something. Or
and there's
whatever.
A giant map right in the middle of the program that, you know, lists all of the different right. vendors and exactly where they're at.
And a lot of the vendors at the Porcupine Freedom Festival take alternative currencies like Bitcoin or silver to a lesser extent, but Bitcoin's huge.
And Dogecoin. Dogecoin like took over the festival last year.
No. I don't think so.
It was DogeFest. I mean, that's what I learned from Shire Dude.
I don't think so.
I also learned Jump Cuts from Shire Dude.
There was one place that took Dogecoin that I
noticed. Daryl, are you ever going to get over that? Like, ever?
All of his videos that I've seen just have weird random jump cuts, and it makes no sense to me.
It's how you compress time, right?
Well, there are some, like, inside baseball jokes, you know, some inside jokes, but there's, like, a level base funny. If you watch a Shire Dude video and you don't laugh, then there's something wrong with you.
I also don't laugh at Tim and Eric, and like it seems to be the same sort of
I don't know who Tim and Eric is.
Style of humor.
So anyway, back to Porkfest. Porkfest.com, you can go there. Tickets, I imagine you cannot get at this point online.
I believe today is the last day you can purchase them online.
Okay.
After today, you have to purchase them at registration.
And I don't know what that's going to cost. I think probably
$100.
For the 7-day pass, it is $100.
Not bad.
There will be, you know, the 1-day passes. Those are $45 for a day pass. Yep. But if you're going to come for 1 day, you might as well come for them all.
Well,
it's just an experience.
Some people can't come up for
True.
All of them. It's a big commitment to take an entire week off of work to come to Porkfest, but it's worth it if you can. If you can do all 7 days, it's awesome from, you know, the word go, but it gets really big on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So if you can only come up for a few days, come up for that final weekend. Again, it starts this Sunday. It goes through the following Sunday. So the 21st through the 28th, it's going to be a blast.
And the first Porkfest that I came to was in 2010, and I think Porkfest was officially Thursday through Saturday or
I remember
Sunday
back when it was
or something.
That way, yeah.
And then it started like people were getting there on Wednesday and then they started getting there on Tuesday. And
people are there right
it
now.
It was what about
I'll be up there tomorrow.
2 years ago when it officially became a week long event.
It right. was 4 years ago because that was my first year. It was a 4-day event. I went for the entire week.
I love it. It's just so much fun. And I don't even have the schedule in front of me. I know there's a boatload of special guest speakers. Is there anyone that you're aware of, Ceslin, that you're looking forward to?
Lynn Ulbrich.
Yes, Lynn Ulbrich. That's a great one. There is an opening speech this year. I'm having trouble remembering her name. It's the unschool or the free range.
Yeah. Lenore Skenazy, I believe is her name.
This is a brand new thing. It's a, you know, kind of an opening event type deal where she's
really
going to be speaking. And then later on, she's going to do like a brainstorming session later on the week with parents about, you know, free range kids and, you know, how to introduce that to society and kind of workarounds and how to get people comfortable with the idea that, you know, these children are like, you know, little adults, and they can handle themselves.
Yeah,
they don't need to be a helicopter.
I was really surprised when I saw they were putting this major speaker. I consider Lenore Skenazy to be one of the biggest speakers at Porkfest because the Free Range Kids blog is huge, and she was called the worst mother of the year, I believe, when she first hit the news for simply letting her son walk home from school, take the subway home from school in New York City. And ever since then, she's been really, you know, blogging about all kinds of stuff where poor parents and families are being attacked by the government just because they want to let their kids go to the park and things like that. She's doing a really good work, and hopefully we'll be able to drag her in to be on Free Talk Live. But she's speaking on Monday.
Monday at 11 o'clock. Jeffrey Tucker is speaking at noon on Monday.
Jeffrey Tucker's a big one. So lots of big names here. And the schedule is just chock full of stuff. You can't do everything at Porkfest.
And
there's
it's not
so
just speakers and events and panels. It's parties and events and our social
big gay
Buzz's
dance party.
The grand finale of Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party.
The last one
I'm
ever.
Hosting a polyamory party. It's a social mixer. Seditious Sirens are going to be throwing a party while they record their show on Wednesday, I think they are.
I don't know. I think
I don't
Friday,
know. There's too many things.
But whatever.
There's
but the
so
schedule's
many
there. Go and, you know, try to get an idea for everything that's happening. Go to porkfest.com, PORCFEST.com. There's stuff for kids. There's stuff for families. There's stuff for, you know, young people, singles, you know, couples, whatever. It's
there
all
are
happening.
There's two cooking events. There's Brunch Fest, which is in its second year. And then there's also the One Pot Cook-Off that is, I believe, Thursday.
Correct. It actually is right before the poly party. So you could go eat your food and then come to the poly party.
All right. This I saw, and I thought it might have been a mistake, but no, apparently it is, a masquerade ball. What do you know about it? Do you know anything about this?
As far as I have a broad idea about it, there's going to be dancing classes all week long, and then those will be the type of dances they do during the masquerade ball. But there's
And that's Mayor Tony that's running that, correct?
Correct. In the past, it's always been like the main organizer kind of doing everything. This year, there's a whole team of people with lead organizers doing different things. There's someone doing strictly just the pavilion, someone doing Agora Valley, someone doing the Creating Communities tent, which is, I'm really excited about that track because that's all, you know, it's DIY stuff. It's shows. There's going to be improv, beergasm. There's just...
There's yoga.
I mean, yoga.
Yuri is hosting yoga at this, and I believe there's another one.
There's
going to
be a cuddle party. Randy is having a cuddle party. That's going to be fun.
Brian Sovereign will be recording Sovereign Tech live.
So much happening. We're going to bring as much of it to you as we can in the 3 hours a night that we'll have to talk about it. Ceslin, you're heading down there tomorrow to get set up and get rolling. So thanks for coming on tonight. I know you're super busy. I appreciate it. See you tomorrow online. In the meantime, freetalklive.com. Don't forget Daryl. He's got a website. It's fpp.cc. See you tomorrow.
Well, hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Seditious Sirens is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, June 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.19 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,202 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $249. Antiwar.com reports, the first 3 days of the Yemen peace talks in Geneva were pretty unproductive, but at least no one got hit. The situation took a turn for the worse on Thursday when the Houthis' attempt to hold a press event was attacked by supporters of the Hadi faction. Houthi delegate Hamza al-Houthi was delivering his address to the assembled media when one of the Hadi delegates rushed the stage and threw a shoe at him. Shoes started flying back and forth despite